dying today.
We made it?
We made it!
Alright.
It's 7:59!
Hey, Joan, we are on time.
It's 7:59! We made it! This is,
Oh, my God. Have one camera for that,
huh? How you doing?
Hey! Feels good to be on time.
Feels what is that to be on time tonight?
Woo! Hold on a second, I gotta save this now. Look at this. Look at everybody in chat. Oh my God, they're on time.
Yeah, we're on time.
Let me ask this question. Look at
what?
The camera right there in front of us. Do we have like a sun beam of light? Like
it does kind of look like a beam of light.
Go, wait, how do I do it? Like,
what do you got? Jesus? Is Jesus coming?
Who's
got
Jesus?
Oh, you
know what it is? I see what it is when I turn and look. Oh, wait, that can't be that much. I don't know. There's like cigarettes. You know how you smoke cigarettes and like yellow shit grows on your wall and your ceiling?
Yeah.
It looks like that, but that doesn't explain that big fucking beam. And like God is like on the air right now, I think. Look at that. Shining down from heaven.
So, let me get this out of the way. Right off the bat.
All right.
What we did is I took down some notes for tonight's show. And we've got all the news and the rumors and all the big stories over the past week.
A lot of stuff to talk about.
I want to get this out of the way.
I am determined to
hold it together.
Hopefully
right now.
That's got to help. Just stare at the light.
It has been a rough week around here. Last Thursday, lost my rabbit, lost Kai. I woke up, you know, I put a message out on Facebook that Kai wasn't doing very good, and now I see
why you say you call them the family, because they were very cool about that whole situation. Mm. Like, you know, they got your back when you come to them and have something serious to say, and they're like, oh man, I lost this pet, or, you know, and they're all with you, you know.
Yeah.
They're supportive.
Yeah.
Grit your fucking teeth and get through it. Come on, man.
So anyway, I put a message out on Facebook that Kai wasn't doing good, man. He was just, you know, the last couple days, you had seen him. He wasn't doing
it
good.
It was obvious.
And man, I was a wreck on I think it was Thursday.
And Friday and Saturday.
I was just a wreck, man. And the hardest thing was trying to hold it together for the kids out there, man. And
so
of course,
I can't believe you said it that loud.
I've got the hardest part of you know, going out in the kitchen and putting them into a box. And you got to pick them up. You got to put them into a box.
The fact
you got to take
them
to the Humane Society.
That graphic and descriptive on
da, 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 da. And I had to go down to the Humane Society. And God, you know, the woman, she was so polite behind the counter,
was
man.
She hot?
And she was a good-looking chick.
Right.
She was a good-looking chick.
That probably
chick,
made it easier to keep it together.
I'm trying to keep it together. And
I'm
then
sorry,
I said,
man. I'm sorry. How
I
every
said
week
to her,
in the same spot?
So I said to her, she said, do you want somebody to come out and get him, or you want to bring him in? I said, I'll go out and get him. I tell you, man, I popped open the trunk, dude.
And that's
and
your last
gotta,
minute with him.
You,
I got you.
You've got to get that
you.
One final kiss at a box, dude. And then when I walked back in and I handed the woman the box, She said, I'm so sorry again. I couldn't.
Oh, why did she say that?
I couldn't get the words out of my mouth, man. I couldn't talk.
Damn.
So finally, we got back home, and I put the wrong phone number, because she's asking me a billion questions. And I put the wrong phone number on the thing, so I had to call her back, and it was her that answered. And I said, hey, by the way, I just want to apologize when I... You know, I said I couldn't get the words.
Sounds like you might have been able to make a move on this young lady.
I said I couldn't.
A missed opportunity or not.
I said I couldn't. I couldn't get the words out of my mouth to her. But so anyways, rest in peace to Kai, man. Kai's been on here a couple of different times.
We've had him on,
You know,
on the camera,
whether it's off air, after we go off the air.
No, we've had him on the camera, on the show.
Pets become part of your family, man, and we had Kai for 7 years, man, 7-8 years, but all you can do is look back and say that Kai had an awesome home for 7 or 8 years, dude, just a great home, wasn't caged up all day, we would let Kai run around here, man.
You would never know where he was half the time.
God, ate our fucking internet cord, how many times, man, how many times did Kai eat that goddamn internet cord, man?
You could guarantee anytime, I don't know if it was like, you said it was like this for you, anytime I'd go to the kitchen for anything. He'd hop his little ass in there because I would always spoil him. Anytime I saw him, I'd grab a big handful of his food and I'd say, rock and roll. And every time I started doing that, it became a ritual. I'd go out there, and he'd see me, and he'd, oh, hop, 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 right into the kitchen.
Right,
look around.
Right.
And the times we didn't have food was, I won't get into that, but yeah. He was an awesome pet.
He'll be missed. He'll be loved forever. Definitely be missed. Maybe that's caught right there, man.
Maybe that's not looking over. Maybe he's shining down, saying, yo, let me one final appearance. You never know.
Maybe that Kai right there. But anyway, Kai, we're going to miss you, and...
Why is everybody comparing, I'm sorry.
And let me say one other thing, man, is I went on Facebook, and I tried not to do too many posts about it, but man, you and I, let's be honest.
Yeah.
We ain't got a lot of friends. We don't do a lot. You know what I'm saying, dude?
I don't have a lot of friends in New York, that's for damn sure, yeah.
We sit here, man, and we work all day, so I ain't got really, to be honest with you, I ain't got nobody to vent to. I ain't got nobody to say this stuff to.
I tried to let him vent to me a few times, and he would just walk away and just go be by himself, which
I
understood.
I can't get the words out, man. So anyway, I go on Facebook, and I see, you know, there's 7,000 of you guys, about 7,000 of you guys, that are on my Facebook page, man. You know, I did a couple of different posts about it, man. And I'll be honest with you, man. I wrote them fucking posts with tears streaming out of every one of them posts that I put up on Facebook, man. I had tears boiling down my face, man. And then the thing that was awesome is there was not one negative comment, man, and I read through every single fucking comment.
You would think at least one troll would get in there. No.
One troll.
That's why I said I understand that you call them a family.
You would think that one troll would jump in there and say something stupid.
Yeah.
Every single fucking comment from the top to the bottom, and I'm reading through these comments, man. Y'all motherfuckers made it worse, man. I'm sitting there going, oh my god. The comments were awesome. So, big thank you, and anybody that's owned a pet, you know what I mean, dude? They become a part of the family, and it was just, you guys are fucking awesome. So thank you for that. And that's
with a pet, it's all love. There's no negative. You don't get in an argument with a pet. You don't break up with a pet and not see him for, like, it's love from the time you get
them. Especially dogs and a cat when you walk home and,
yes,
and they're happy
to see you. It's all positive.
They're right there
Everything about it is positive.
They're right there waiting for you,
man.
So,
you know, they make mistakes. They poop on the floor, whatever stuff. But their connection, their bond with you is all, there's nothing negative about it.
Yeah.
There is no negativity in that bond, and that's why it's such a special bond.
Right.
But, yeah, and I can completely relate. I've had, I don't even want to get into it. I've had a million.
I know. It's
animals,
just, it's
human
so,
beings, you name it, bro.
It's so hard losing a pet. So, R.I.P., rest in peace to Kai, you up there in animal heaven somewhere. But
I'm curious as to why everybody in the chat room, they're doing, now it's covered. Kevin Boone's the last one, but if you go up, there's like 8 in a row. It's Matt Nash, it's Big Daddy Boone, it's every combination of Kevin Nash's name with mine replacing it that you can think of.
What's that all about?
Is it the beard? Does this look like a Nash thing?
I don't remember Nash's beard.
Because you know what's interesting, about that? We have the same birthday, me and Kevin Nash.
Do you?
July 9th.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, all right. Yeah.
Okay.
And he kind of looks like Tim.
Yeah, a little bit.
My stepdad.
A little bit.
Yeah. So
I don't think you look like Nash.
I don't look like him at all. That's why I'm asking. So it just occurred to me when I looked at the screen, oh, maybe it's the goatee.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, they say I do. All right, that's what it is. They all think I look like Nash tonight.
So, you ready for this?
I got like
We're going to do a new format every week. I talked to you about it before we came on here tonight. And basically, what I've done right here, my apologies for the horrible, horrible spelling, but what I have done is gone through the past week, and I've got the biggest stories that we've had.
You should see the handwriting. It's amazing.
It's atrocious. I'm sure they're just, that's all. But anyways, I scribbled these notes on here, and we're going to run down the big stories. We're only going to, you know, chime in. Yeah, there's a lot this week. I mean, this is a whole fucking page.
It's a whole page.
But, so we're going to open the show every week, and we're going to give you guys the biggest stories over the past week, from last Tuesday to this Tuesday.
Yeah.
You know,
that way we get to all the cool shit, and we don't waste an hour and a half on Raw. Like
we're not
idiots.
We're not going head-to-head with Main Event this week, as WWE Main Event is no longer airing on the WWE Network due to basically overseas in the United Kingdom. They've got a deal with Sky Sports. I believe it's the UK, correct?
No, you're Scott Hall because of the 5 o'clock shadow.
Oh, yeah.
The Outsiders.
So, what we're going to do...
That's how dark it is. It's on camera. You can see
it. We're not going head-to-head with Main Event tonight, but we are going head-to-head with the POTUS tonight.
The fuck is a POTUS?
The fuck's a POTUS?
President
of the United States.
That's how you say POTUS?
POTUS.
Okay. What, is doing a State of the Union address?
State of the Union address tonight.
God, I'm good at, I swear to God, I'm so good at initial, when people do, what is it called, acronyms?
Huh?
I'm so good at them. Yeah. Even ones I've never heard of or seen before. I'll read them online, and I'll stare at it long enough that I'll be like, oh, it's blah, 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 blah,
well,
blah.
He's not on here.
I just did
here.
It the other day on Facebook. I saw somebody do like a IC HEM, HMU, or something like that, and I stared at it. Fucking forever, and then I thought, oh, I got it, without looking it up, without cheating, no Google.
He doesn't come on until 9 o'clock. He goes from nine to ten thirty. So we got an hour here before we go head to head with President Obama here for our national, you know, State of the Union address, and then our Governor Cuomo, does the State of the State tomorrow.
What's the rap on Cuomo? Is he blind?
Our governor?
Yeah.
Governor Cuomo?
Yeah.
No.
Who was the black, blind governor that New York had forever?
Oh, David...
I know the last name. I won't know his first name.
David is the first name.
Oh, wait.
Name.
Was it...
Patterson. Was... Patterson.
Is that right?
David Patterson.
Okay.
Former governor of New York.
Who
is black,
Giuliani
is blind.
Beat to become governor? That was part of the...
George Pataki.
Pataki's the name. I was
George
trying to think Pataki. All right, so Patterson's the blind one.
Right, and then David Patterson took over after Pataki... And then Cuomo, Mario Cuomo, used to be the governor of New York. Now his son, Andrew Cuomo, is the governor of New York State. So.
The amount of torn quad jokes that are going into that chat room right now. I love it. It's on Facebook.
So listen.
Writing this post caused me to tear my quad, and it's like a picture of Kevin Nash holding his leg. And
any story that I do on Kevin Nash, somebody will always comment.
I know,
whether
that's
it be
I
on
see
the,
it, your shit.
Whether it be on the main website or on the Facebook, somebody always comments, I got a torn quad while reading this post.
Yeah.
Or Kevin
Maniac says, Boone goes 5 minutes without a smoke, pulls quad.
It's always, any Nash post, always. Is a quad joke in there. All right, so here we go.
McMahon, remember when McMahon, especially with the Rumble coming up, remember when McMahon takes his jacket off, slams it down, does the fucking big time Vince McMahon walk to the ring, and then as soon as he's yelling, he's pointing, he gets in the ring, you motherfucker, and he sits right back down because he tears both quads as soon as he gets up. You remember that?
I know.
Funniest fucking thing I've ever seen in my life.
All right, here we go. We got to move on because we got a lot of news and there's a lot to talk about on Raw last night with the Raw Reunion show. So,
great.
But, one quick thing. Did you know on Twitter yesterday that there was a Ryan Clark death hoax that somebody put up and said, rest in peace to Dirt Sheet reporter Ryan Clark, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
I got all these messages yesterday on Twitter from a couple of different people, and I'm thinking, I'm
well, we actually found a lookalike. This isn't even really him.
Well, there's a Ryan Clark that plays for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
A kicker?
NFL. Not a kicker.
I thought he was a kicker.
No, he's not a kicker. Okay. He's not a kicker. But, anyways, we said that we were going to have some guests. I went on my Facebook page today. You guys know it, man. If you check my Facebook, I went on Twitter, told all you guys to slam Tammy Sitch, Sonny, slam her with messages. Here's the deal with Sonny, and I hate to say it, but I'm going to say it. And I even put it up about a month ago that Tammy wasn't doing well. And basically, what I think, and this is all me... allegations, but Tammy, what'll happen is she will come online, she will do a Skype chat, you know, like last Tuesday. She will get money. The money comes in.
I saw the list of things she'll do that you posted.
She is nowhere to be found. She hasn't been on her Twitter in the last 5 or 6 days. She's not on social media. I can't get a hold of her through email. I can't get a hold of her through Twitter DMs. Nothing. She gets this quick... Go ahead.
She has a listing, and you posted it on your Facebook. Remember, like, what she'll do. This is $5. This is $10. This, you know that listing you posted with her?
Right.
One of them said, see the girls. You know what that means, right?
Absolutely.
What?
See the titties.
She's fucking $10 for my titties.
Right.
Oh, God, what happened? Why?
This is what happens. And I...
Crack.
I have seen it. Time. It's,
sorry.
It's...
What is it?
Probably Coke.
Pills?
Probably Coke.
Coke, okay.
To be honest. But this is what happens, is... Every couple of months, Tammy will come out, and she'll do something
to stir things up. Yeah.
This time it was Ashley Massaro. Before it was somebody else, right?
Yeah.
She gets her name back on the dirt sheets. Her name was trending number one on Twitter last week when we
came
on
here.
Here.
I know, yeah.
So she comes back, she stirs things up. She gets her name trending on Twitter. Everybody's, wow, Tammy is back in the... They go to her Twitter account. She's got a plug up on her Twitter account. Hey, Skype me. She gets a boatload of money. Last Tuesday night, she got a boatload of money.
How many followers she got?
Thousands. Thousands.
Hundreds of thousands?
I would guess. But
she's a hot chick. Usually the hot chicks get way big numbers.
So she gets a boatload of money because you know how pro wrestling fans are. I mean, little nerdy...
Oh, there's a million 12-year-olds that just read, yo, I can see your titties and jerk off. Like, right in front, like, you're staring at me, and I can, $10.
She gets a boatload of money, okay? She gets a boatload of money, it comes in, and the only way that they can pay her is via PayPal or Western Union.
I know,
so she wants the money immediately.
You know why?
You can't pay by credit card, you can't pay by cash, you can't mail cash in the mail. She wants it immediately by Western Union or PayPal, so that it comes right to her. So she gets a boatload of money.
You can't tax it.
Can't tax it.
That's why.
Can't tax it.
That's why she only accepts it those ways. That way nobody can fucking claim it later.
For some reason, after the Tuesday night Skype chat, she disappears. And she's nowhere to be found. I can't get a hold of her. We've tried to phone her. We've tried to email her. We've tried to DM her. Right. Nothing.
Yeah.
She will not. She doesn't pick up. So, or the phone's turned off. So you can't get a hold of her.
Showing some 13-year-old titties while he went off in
Utah. Where do you think she is after getting that money
and
all of a sudden nowhere to be seen? But I guarantee you, once that money runs out from last Tuesday night, she's going to resurface. She's going to be back on Twitter. And she's going to stir up more drama. And then you know what? When she stirs up more drama, you're going to see a post on her Facebook page that says, I'm Skyping tonight. Anybody want to Skype with me tonight? Money comes in.
She's got her Tony Montana-sized trash bag of Coke, you know. She's got her 800,000 pills, whatever she does. She can go off for 2 months, fucking stare at a wall, you know, or a TV screen or something, and do her drugs.
So we can't get her on?
Throw her legs open for whoever the douchebag of the moment is. And when that runs out, then she comes back.
So Tammy is not going to be here tonight. I've been trying to get a hold of her all week long. Nothing. Ashley Mazzaro, I sent a direct message to last Tuesday night when we were doing this show. Never heard back from here. Sean Waltman is down to do it, but is currently traveling home from Raw last night. Josh Barnett, we still don't have booked, but I tried.
Did you answer back?
Tried all week. Did I answer back to who?
To the agent that you were talking to, the publicist that you were talking
to.
The
Barnett interview? No, I want to check that with you, and then we can set up a date.
You keep saying that. I said any week I will do that interview. Just tell me in advance, and I'll research and get the question. I already pretty much could do it. I could probably, if he called right now, I could interview him. I know enough.
Okay.
So anytime you want, set it up.
Then we can...
Any of these people you're naming, I could do.
I will email her later tonight, and you can...
Do it up. All of them.
Send the email with me. All right, so that's the deal with the guest and the death threat for me. On Twitter. All right, here we go. Are you ready? We're going to do this real quick, and then we're going to get into Monday Night Raw 0 to 100 real quick.
0 to 100 real quick. Oh, like, we're going to accelerate?
Like Drake. 0 to 100 real quick.
I can't even believe you would know that reference, but okay. Fucking guy hates Drake.
I don't like Drake, but 0 to 100.
You think I hate John
White
Jones.
White boy real quick.
I don't, but yeah.
You got a beef with John Jones, but we'll get to that here in a minute.
He's a phony asshole doesn't mean I don't like him.
All right, so you ready?
As a fighter.
So here we go.
Yes.
Bully Ray. A lot of talk about Bully Ray, WWE, TNA.
Yeah.
TNA negotiating with a Bully Ray for a TNA return to the company. Not sure what they've offered him. Now, some rumors came out today, and I don't know where they came from. Maybe you do, but... Talk about the Dudley Boys returning to WWE, appearing in the Royal Rumble. I have no idea where that stuff started, but the last we heard that he was back in talks with TNA, and there were no plans for the Royal Rumble. That's not to say that if WWE offers the Dudley Boys a deal to return to WWE, and they can reach some sort of agreement between now and Sunday... That's not to say the Dudleys may not come back to the Royal Rumble, but I don't know where that story originated.
They can't come out together, so I don't know why they would do it that way, because then it would be one at a time.
Yeah, and it's like, all right, you got D-Von here, but is Bully going to come out? Or you got Bully here, but is D-Von going to come out?
Exactly. If you're going to do it, save it to where they can come out as a unit, and you're like, oh, shit.
Come out together.
Oh, it's like if just D-Von comes out, you know, you get a half-ass pop, half-ass excitement, because you don't know if you get the full thing yet. Or vice versa, although I would be satisfied with just Bully Ray as a singles guy based on his TNA run, his Bullet Ray.
Absolutely.
I thought he
was
the best heel in the business.
He was the
any
top
company
heel
in America.
He was the top heel.
Agreed.
In TNA in any
no,
company.
Yeah, fuck TNA,
yeah,
any
absolutely.
Company.
Absolutely.
Top heel.
So I don't know where the
WWE's is really light on heels. Name their top heels right now. Big
not
Show,
many.
Kane.
Just not many, I know.
Seth Rollins, that's about
Seth
it.
Seth Rollins would be their biggest,
yeah.
Biggest deal. But anyway, I don't know where the Dudley Boys, but the last we heard, Bully Ray was back in talks with TNA to return to that company. Kevin Nash and Heath Slater charges against both of those guys dropped. As it
both
pertains to Heath Slater, the deal there was the Statue of Limitations. Statute of limitations had expired, so there was no way.
Yeah, that was from 2011.
5+ years, whatever it is, wherever wherever the incident took place, the statute of limitations had expired, and that is whatever. Kevin Nash.
Kind of sucks
thing.
Though, because let's just assume for a second it was true, and he beat the shit. And I would do it quick. He beat the shit out of some female security guard like he was alleged to have done. That means you could go get drunk and fucked up at a party and
that woman
and rape some chick, and as long as you can hide around for 4 years and avoid fucking getting caught, when you go to court, you can say, guys, that happened 4 years ago. Or, that never happened, but if it did, it was 4 years ago. And,
that story.
All right, go to get too late.
That story time. From the get-go, when
oh,
it
yeah.
first
everybody
came out,
it, I know.
That woman was completely...
A non-credible witness.
I'm sorry, but...
Listen, nobody believed her.
Nobody believed her, and I don't think anybody believes her now, and we never believed her. There were just so many different
and a lot of
people
who
that,
were there
that
at that after party, because you got to think, it's the official WrestleMania after party. Tons of people are there.
Right.
There were plenty of witnesses, and everybody's like, no, that's bullshit.
Yeah,
this girl's like got an agenda.
She was...
Who knows? I don't, you know, but that's what everybody
that,
said.
I... 99% sure that didn't happen.
Well, this one did happen, but
Kevin Nash got in a fight with his son on New Year's Day or New Year's Eve, early in the
Christmas
morning
Eve.
Hours, or Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
Right. Christmas Eve. They had been drinking. Basically, more information came out on this that Kevin Nash actually
makes
used
the 911 phone
his
call
signature power bomb on his son, dude. He hit his own son.
He jackknifed him.
He jackknifed power bombed his own fucking son on Christmas Eve.
He should be arrested for that. Alone if you had
but anyways, it sounds like that was a case of a drunken night. They woke up the next morning. Listen, everybody got drunk. Everybody was fucked up. The son, maybe not Nash, but the son came home. The son fucked up. Realized he had fucked up the next morning, and charges were dropped against Nash. Now, there are charges still pending against the son. Mm. He's going to have to go in court to answer to that. Hopefully, Nash says, listen, I've worked things over with my son. Let's give him a light penalty, and hopefully...
It's funny, because...
That's in the past now.
Tim,
so.
We said, is like a fat version of Kevin Nash. My stepdad, Tim.
Right.
Rest in peace. But, back when it was Tim, my mom, me, Jamie, everybody, there was nights where I had drunken fucking psycho outfits, and he would have to fucking throw me down. And
right.
You know what
right,
I mean?
Right,
but
right.
We never called the cops.
Never
we
called
were,
the cops,
we
right.
We just handled it in-house. Yeah.
Right.
But, yeah, I can relate, believe me.
All right, so...
I probably had a beard as long as Tristan's at
by
the
way,
time, too.
Yeah?
Yeah, go ahead.
And by the way, Kevin Nash obviously returned last night on Raw once WWE found out that the charges had been dropped.
Because he was suspended.
He was suspended from the Legends contract that he's under. WWE reinstated that contract as soon as they found out that everything was smoothed over.
And then I'll throw
in,
a teaser out, and then you go to the next one.
Match.
Was Scott Hall fucked up last night? We'll find out. Anyways, what's next on the list?
Scott Hall looked amazing.
He
last
looked
night.
Good, but his voice, man, something's up with
no.
There was some stammering or some slurring
really?
Or a little bit.
Are you serious?
He didn't sound like Scott Hall. He sounded like Scott Hall with like a
I disagree.
He sounded like Scott Hall with a speech impediment. That's what he sounded like.
Really?
He sounded like Scott Hall with a speech impediment.
I disagree completely.
I did everybody here in the
but that's the way he's always
no, but
always talk like that.
But it's worse. No, he would go, or did everybody here in Dallas, Texas. That's Scott Hall in this one. Or did everybody here in Dallas. Like he had peanut butter in the roof of his mouth.
Really?
That's what I heard. I don't know.
I don't know. I'm going to call you crazy. I thought
oh,
Scott...
Oh, Rick Brown's 100% right. Ric Flair was drunk as a fucking skunk. There ain't
Flair,
no way he was.
Flair, no doubt.
He was all worked up, bro.
Flair, no doubt.
Yeah.
Scotty Hall, on the other hand, I thought Scott looked amazing last night. I didn't think he was slurring his words. I thought he was...
That wasn't a bad
Scott,
slur.
Scott
there was just
good.
Like something different about his voice. I'm not even saying he was drunk.
Uh-huh.
But there was something about his voice. And if you play that clip side by side with a clip from... 98, 99. And yeah, it's not even like, oh, he's older now. No, it's like, what happened to his voice?
Yeah, but drugs will do that to you over the years.
It doesn't screw your voice up like that.
Over the years, listen, former drug addicts, and then you see them now, they're not the same person.
Sitting right here, homie.
I don't know, man.
Sound exactly the same.
I don't know. Flair, now Flair, I agree. Flair was shit-faced last night.
He had a few drinks at least.
All right, TNA announced
a... at the post-fight press conference.
We're getting to that.
You remember at the post-fight, Dana's like, yo, we need to wrap this up before the whiskey kicks in. He's babbling over here.
Right.
You remember that? You watched it, right?
It was awesome, right? Yeah, right. All right, TNA announced a bunch of signings last week. Awesome Kong is back with the company.
Right.
Probably the biggest name that they re-signed last week was Jeff Hardy. They announced
a ton of names last week.
It was Awesome Kong, Manic, Gail Kim, Jeff Hardy, Kenny King, and Mark Andrews.
Oh, so we're not including
the winner
a week before where like everybody was.
Yeah, they signed a bunch. But
like,
the ones that they announced all in one day this past,
right.
You know, in the last couple of weeks, Kurt Angle, Ethan Carter,
yeah.
People like that. But Awesome Kong, Manic, the Gail Wolves, Kim, Jeff Hardy, Mark Andrews, and Kenny King. Jerry Lawler over to WWE SmackDown. Couple of different reasons why they moved Jerry Lawler to SmackDown.
Or one of them was that they're phasing him off of television. They're phasing him out of his role and off of television.
Mm-hmm.
And they consider moving him to SmackDown less exposure. It's like a move down in class, and it's like a phasing out process. You don't just rip him off Raw, he's never to be seen again. He goes from, just like Jim Ross. Jim Ross went from Raw to SmackDown to NXT to fucking gone. That's what supposedly happened with Lawler.
Then
the other theory was that, no, that SmackDown changed nights, and we want to give it like a oomph with the commentary, give them their own A-level commentary team. Michael Cole and Jerry Lawler from Raw are also on SmackDown now.
Mm-hmm.
And now Lawler's not even on Raw. He's only, if you want to hear the King, Gotta watch SmackDown.
Yeah,
and he's viewed, along with Jim Ross, as like, because of the Attitude
Era. He's the number two guy.
He's the one, punch guy, yeah.
Sting going to be appearing at WrestleMania Access. We'll get into
and
Sting.
And WrestleMania.
Obviously.
I don't even know why that's news. But.
He's going to be at WrestleMania as well.
They saw it come out today.
They started the angle last night on Raw, obviously.
No,
they started the angle
on
Survivor Series.
Yeah.
Followed it up on Raw last night. Looks
Did
like
you see that
be,
coming?
Looks like it's going to be Sting and Triple H at WrestleMania, which is what we've been telling you
right,
guys.
That's obviously.
Did I see Sting on Raw last night? No, I did not.
You didn't see that coming?
I didn't see it.
And you know what? It had been reported. I had heard whispers about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I ignored it because I said, you know what? I think they got so much going on. That would be watered down and like it wouldn't get the right exposure. It wouldn't be like, oh shit, Sting was on Raw. It would be like, yo, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall and Shawn Michaels and Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair and Sting. He would just be one of like a big list of big names. You know,
I don't know how I say this without you jumping all over me. And granted, I will say you disagreed and didn't think that either man was going to appear on Raw last night. You were absolutely
awesome
right.
Tender, yeah.
But I had said just strictly due to the fact that they were in Texas
in Dallas,
I had figured two guys, two big names that live or reside in Texas are The Undertaker and Steve Austin. Now, with WrestleMania coming up, I had figured, listen, if The Undertaker is going to work a match at WrestleMania, why not announce it? And I realize we haven't even got to the Royal Rumble yet.
Let alone Fastlane.
Normally they announce his... If he's going to be at the Rumble, or if he's going to be at WrestleMania, they announce it after the Rumble pay-per-view.
Yeah.
I had figured maybe they'll announce it last night. Raw reunion, The Undertaker comes back, announces, and then you've got the next 3 or 4 months going into WrestleMania to hype it up.
And then
didn't happen.
All right, well, let's just go for a second and say that happened.
Okay.
And his opponent was Bray Wyatt.
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck do they do with Bray Wyatt for the next 3 or 4 months?
What do you do with the Rumble?
He's got to promote Undertaker, but he's also got to wrestle people and promote pay-per-view matches for two shows, not just one. You got the Rumble and Fastlane. So he's got to do these big programs and pretty much just be... still promote The Undertaker, and
All I needed last night was for The Undertaker to appear on stage and announce that he was going to be wrestling
Look
at WrestleMania.
Look at that sign that he does, yeah.
All he's got to do is confirm. He doesn't tell me that he's going to be facing Bray Wyatt. He doesn't tell me who he's going to be facing. I don't care at this point. All I want to know at this point is The Undertaker going to be at WrestleMania 31? Is he going to be there? And last night, that's all they had to do. And
you
like
know what
he said,
been a
come out
to do it?
Point to the
Not
sign
even do
or
that. Yeah, yeah, do that. Have him come out. Pitch black. You know how they turn the lights off when he comes out?
Right.
He has a spotlight. Ready?
Spotlight.
Follow me. Spotlight carries him to the ring like Batista used to do.
Okay.
He just, it's dark spotlight because it's dark Undertaker. Nobody's like, what's going on? This is normal. Undertaker comes out in the dark.
Okay.
He points to the fucking WrestleMania sign.
That's it.
Oh, no.
That's it.
No. And then all of a sudden, because his gimmick is the lantern, fucking Wyatt's up on the fucking balcony right next to the Mania sign, like on the rafters. But he's standing there, right, like this. He's standing right here. You're the WrestleMania sign. He takes his lantern, shines the light on WrestleMania.
Right.
Shines the light, looks down at Undertaker, and then just starts doing his scary laugh.
Matt Boone the Booker.
That's crazy.
Matt Boone the Booker. I like
that's
it.
That's crazy.
I like it, man.
I'd be excited for that.
All I needed to see last night, I mean, you went a little bit deeper there, which would have been awesome to see. But all I needed last night was the Undertaker point to the sign, WrestleMania. That way I know, all right, the Undertaker's confirmed for WrestleMania. Don't announce who he's going to face, Bray Wyatt. You can do that later, whether it be at the Royal Rumble, at the Fastlane pay-per-view, wherever you're going to do that, you can do that later. But just announce that Taker's going to be there last night for WrestleMania.
It's so sad to see people's reactions in the chat room. Like, one guy says that he expects Taker at Raw next week. One guy says...
Next week?
Yeah, one guy says Taker will be the surprise number 30 in the Royal Rumble. Like, guys, this happened in the Attitude Era. Cool shit like that would happen. You cannot have high expectations like that these days. Your expectations have to be right here. And then when anything cool happens, you can enjoy it because you're like, wow, something cool finally happened.
The Undertaker...
Like the APA NWO thing last night. Like, that was badass. We don't get that every week.
Taker is... Taker's not going to be in the Rumble. If Taker's going to work a match, it's got to be one match every year, WrestleMania. It's not going to be the Rumble. It's not going to be on Raw. It's going to be WrestleMania. It's going to be one match. It's going
to
be every year.
I mean, I understand, because the Rumble, there's ways to do it, like where he doesn't even really have to work.
You've got other guys in there.
Especially if he comes out at 30. There's only two guys left. He clotheslines him. He doesn't have to take one bump in that whole match.
It ain't going to happen.
Yeah, I know. I know it's not going to happen, but I'm saying they could.
All right, so Sting WrestleMania Access is going to be at WrestleMania as well. I'm going to tie this into the UFC stuff we're going to do. Mark Merrow, I don't know if you saw this speech.
I saw it was trending, so I knew it was big, but I didn't look at it.
He cut, basically he's going to elementary schools and colleges and high schools, and he's cutting these motivational speeches, and they are awesome, man. Well, one of the speeches he went on, it was about 5 minutes long. He talked about his mother and not calling his mother, and she later passed away. And all he thought was, why didn't I call my mom?
Oh,
I
don't say that.
I should have called my mother.
Fucking screw my head up, man.
I know.
My mom's birthday was last week.
It got over 4 million views on YouTube. Basically, it went viral. And we put it up on the website, so you guys should really check that out, because it's a really, really awesome motivational type speech that that Merrow
did. I'm glad I didn't watch it.
And I give him all the credit in the world, man, for going to elementary schools and high schools and teaching these kids.
I'm gonna press the fuck out.
I've
been talking to my mom like 5 years.
Today, big announcement, WWE TV tapings being held in Texas. They were in Dallas, Texas last night. Speaking of Dallas, Texas, they held a media event for the media today, and there were some fans there as well. Vince McMahon was there, John Cena was there, Mark Henry, Natalya, Stephanie McMahon, bunch of guys.
Vince, you said Vince, right?
Hogan was there as well, Vince McMahon. We put the videos up on the website today. We've been telling you guys for months, WrestleMania 31 is going to be in San Francisco, which we already know.
It's not. It's
going
to be in Santa Clara.
Santa Clara. It's right near San Francisco.
Very close to San Francisco.
Very close.
Yeah.
WrestleMania 32, they finally confirmed today, it's going to be at AT&T Stadium in Dallas, Texas.
Arlington.
Now, they hyped it up to Arlington, Texas. Yeah. Same thing. Dallas. It's going to be at Dallas,
we're in Albany right now. We're not.
And all the news posts on the website, even WWE.com, Dallas, Texas.
In Arlington, Texas.
Dallas, Texas. It's Dallas. But anyways, it's actually Arlington, but... Dallas. It's being billed as Dallas. But the whole
thing
today...
Is that the name of Cowboys Stadium? AT&T?
AT&T.
Is that the Cowboys Stadium?
That's Cowboys Stadium.
Okay.
Brand new stadium. Well, a couple of years old.
Okay. I didn't know that.
Jerry Jones's
I thought Cowboys Stadium was just called Cowboys Stadium.
Jerry World is what they call it. But anyways, they were talking today. I mean, that stadium can hold 110,000 people. All the talk today was, we're going to come in here, we are going to set the all-time WrestleMania attendance record. We're going over 100,000 fans at AT&T Stadium. Good luck
with
that.
You know what the record is?
Good luck
with
that.
In that building?
Yes, I do. The record in the Cowboys Stadium is the NBA All-Star Game of 2000.
That can't be right.
12. I was shocked.
What was the
number? Will you tell them in the chat room? It was.
I don't know what event it was, but I know the number.
110,000 people.
109,000. Yeah.
109,000.
Probably rounded up, probably to 10. Yeah.
It was the NBA.
Oh shit! I didn't know
All-Star
that. 110,000 people watch people dunk basketballs and shit.
All-Star game, wow. Dude. The NBA All-Star game. Right. Ridiculous. We put it up on the website today.
Tim Duncan must have been on fire that year.
I don't know, but 110,000 people, and then
San Antonio's in Texas, right? I don't want to sound stupid.
San Antonio? Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Texas.
Spurs.
Let's see.
What was John Cena's ash comment last night? Does that have something to do with Dallas?
No.
Because you laughed at that. I don't understand it.
No, you know what I'm talking about is the Road Dog with his cotton picking thing last night. And you said that it wasn't a big deal. I got two different emails today saying any backlash to the cotton picking comment.
He said, wait a cotton pick a minute.
Wait a
cotton. That's an expression.
Cotton pick a minute?
Oh, wait, no. Wait a cotton pick a minute. Or wait a cotton pick a second, I think might be even the catchphrase. But that's an expression that everybody uses, yes.
All right.
I'm proud. You can Google it.
I'll take your word on it.
It is an expression.
I'll take your word on it, but when I hear cotton picking, I'm thinking...
You think of slavery, yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't know. All right, so... Toughen Up. They announced Toughen Up is coming back.
That's true, they did, yeah.
This past week.
Casting information came out today.
Bill DeMott teasing on Twitter that he's preparing or he's getting ready.
He's been the head coach in the past.
Maybe he'll be a head coach. But casting call, like you said, came out today.
He's good on that show, too.
He's awesome.
He's such a prick.
What about Austin coming back?
Taz was awesome, too. Taz had the Bill DeMott role before Bill DeMott.
See, Taz can't be there. I mean, obviously with Taz TNA right now.
Taz can't do it. No.
Tough enough.
Taz got a new podcast. Pretty good podcast.
You listen to it?
I listened to the one with Edge.
Pretty good?
The Edge part was good.
Yeah. All right. So we got Tough Enough coming back. It's going to air on the USA Network,
okay.
By the way.
I didn't even know until you just said it. I thought it would be the network, WWE Network.
On the USA Network. Okay. Yeah, it's crazy. All right, WWE Royal Rumble
coming out. They got a TV deal for that.
They got a TV deal.
Oh, shit.
USA Network president came out, commented.
It's so stupid. You got something that finally would get people to sign up for your network. Let's
do it on the network.
Put it on TV.
Do it on the network.
No. We get people to pay commercials for us. Let's put it on
their
USA
way.
Guys, your business model has changed. You need to get people signing up for this fucking
also,
network.
They figure if we can get a TV deal out of the USA Network, we can also plug our network on that way.
What are you
that
plugging?
That way we're getting the rights fees, we're getting the commercial advertisements, we're getting all this stuff to air on the USA Network, and in addition to that, we're also going to plug our WWE Network on Tough Enough. So it's basically two for the price of one, where they get the USA Network deal, they get the advertisements, they get the rights fees, everything else.
Yeah, that's why
on,
they did it.
On Tough Enough, they can also promote the WWE Network. Bonus footage.
The
bonus
same people
coverage.
That watch Tough Enough on USA.
Go to the WWE Network for bonus footage.
So you're advertising to the same audience. It's not like added exposure for the plugs of the network. The same people who watch Raw, less will watch Tough Enough, but it'll be the same people who watch Raw.
Yeah, but it's money. It's all about money, man.
That's what I'm saying.
It's all about money.
If they want to make money, you need to get network subscriptions.
All right, Royal
when those
Rumble.
Numbers come out in what is it? February 12th.
It's gonna be good.
February
12th.
Is that the conference call?
Yeah, and you're gonna have the UK numbers, the Ireland numbers, the Canadian numbers.
It's gonna be
numbers.
A big day. Yeah, we're gonna really learn a lot that day.
And it ain't
we're gonna learn a lot
good.
More the next conference call 3 months
it
after
ain't
that.
Gonna be good. You guys telling us, all right, you people in the chat room and on my Facebook page saying, just wait, Ryan and Boone.
Oh, yeah.
When it launches in Canada and the UK
and
Ireland, you just wait until you see the numbers. I'm telling you.
And you got people saying,
telling you,
everybody bought it for their kids for Christmas, but the numbers will be up. No, it's not, man.
Listen,
the people
when they come out, I want you to make. I know it's
I can't make a prediction.
All right, listen. What are they at right now? About 750.
I don't even 700, remember. 000? I think it's 700 straight.
All right,
we're now
launched in Canada. Right. Well, Canada's on Rogers, so it's gonna be tough.
Yeah, that's confusing.
Okay,
UK just came out.
UK and Ireland. So we've got another month or two before they do the fourth quarter.
No, the number they're announcing in February is from
quarter.
December.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
you're
and right. November was free.
Yeah.
So we don't learn a
so
lot.
We're not gonna have the UK.
We're not gonna learn a lot about that number. It's the next conference call where we really learn.
The one
you really
that.
Learn what is
UK.
This full package
right.
international
right.
exposure help.
You're right.
You know?
You're right. It's not the next one that's going to come because the next one's not going to include the UK numbers. It's only going to include the fourth quarter, and it wasn't overseas at that point in the fourth quarter.
And the third, the November was free.
You're right. It'll be the second.
November was free. Nobody signed up in November because if they signed up, they signed up without paying.
All right. WWE Royal Rumble is coming up this Sunday night on pay-per-view. There is talk that several WWE NXT talents are going to debut in the Rumble. A couple of guys came and debuted. Also, as of right now, and these guys have been contacted, that's not to say that this may not change, but as of right now, your surprise entrance in the Royal Rumble, Diamond Dallas Page, Rob Van Dam, and Bo Dallas. A lot of people asking...
Randy Orton will be in there.
A lot of people asking, Rey Mysterio, we haven't seen him in quite some time.
Rey's a possibility, I doubt it.
Possibility, doubtful.
Yeah.
But
Randy Orton will be in there.
Randy Orton, I agree with.
Add Orton to that list.
DDP, Rob Van Dam, and Bo Dallas, all contacted, all scheduled to be there. It's not to say that that may not change between now and Sunday, but DDP, Rob Van Dam, Bo Dallas, and Randy Orton.
And you'll get a comedy one like JBL or Jerry Lawler or somebody that can
walk
in and get thrown out in 2 seconds, but like get a big pop. And this guy's in it.
Triple H, Monday Night Raw last night. So there's a little kid in the front row, and he starts crying last night, right? Young kid.
During the main event.
Starts crying during the main event, right? And after Raw went off the air, it might have even been when they were on camera.
No,
I didn't see it.
It didn't catch it on camera, but it was fan shot pictures that went.
Okay.
Yeah, but it was during the main event, so it was risky. Because, one producer makes the wrong call, like, yo, camera three, boom, there all of a sudden there's Triple H hugging some crying kid.
Right.
He's not a bad guy anymore, you know what I mean?
What do you think of that, though? He broke character,
and then he gave him a bunch of Cena merchandise.
They took him backstage, and they gave him all this Cena stuff, a bunch of hats and t-shirts and everything else. I thought it was cool, man. I mean, so you got to give major...
Basically, parents, if you have kids and you're going to take them to a WWE TV, tell them to cry. If you're close enough, cry.
We'll go
backstage. Free shit and meet people.
We'll go backstage. Yeah. But Triple H must have been in a pretty good mood last night.
Must have been happy, yeah.
All right, I'm going
to
skip
though he is ashamed of the show, we'll get to that in a little bit.
Yeah, I know.
We'll have fun with that one.
I got to talk about this. Yeah. Listen, Lance Storm and I, several months ago, for some reason I get in Twitter wars with people. I don't know why, man. I
got a big mouth.
I see it.
You do. So do I.
So, Lance Storm wound up blocking me, and listen, I went on Twitter, and I called him a jobber a couple times, and you know what? I woke up the following morning. The following morning, and you know what?
I remember when Taz was going to kill you, because he says
I can admit, I think it was last Tuesday night, I got off here, had a couple of beers in me, went on Facebook and put up that Lance Storm with a jobber. I woke up the next morning and I said, you know what?
You pulled a Josh Matthews.
I deleted the post.
He drunk tweeted.
Pulled a Josh Matthews.
We'll get to that soon.
And I deleted the post and I sent out an apology on Facebook and said, you know what? That came across as pretty fucking immature. And it did, man, to go on Facebook, call somebody a jobber. He's been in the business. I haven't.
From a jobber, he's an amazing talent.
He's an awesome wrestler.
And he's a great trainer, too.
Awesome wrestler.
He's very good.
You know, so
but a great wrestler.
I woke up the following morning, and I said, you know what, that was pretty fucking immature for me to put up jobber and Facebook. So, took the post down and apologized for it. But, you know, he came out today, and John Cena sent out a tweet.
Man, they all got your back. Jesus Christ.
Where he was in the gym. John Cena's in the gym.
I saw
and that. He's doing a deadlift or whatever, lifting weights, right? And he says that I'm a beast or something like that. You guys should all get up and go out and do the same thing. And Lance Storm comes out with this tweet of oh, you insulted all the fans. These are the same fans that support you, John. A little bit insensitive, no? And then the previous week on Raw, he says, that's it. I've had enough. I'm shutting off Monday Night Raw. The Ascension cut a promo about Road Warrior Animal. And I'm shutting off Raw. I'm boycotting
Warrior Hulk.
And then Road Warrior Animal comes out on Facebook and says, I didn't really mind it. It wasn't that bad.
It was wrestling.
So Lance Storm, it's pro wrestling. So Lance Storm, it seems like this dude comes on Twitter Bro, you're overreacting,
hey,
bro.
Hey, if I can be serious for a minute. He's a little...
yeah. Tell me.
He's a little too... No, that's his catchphrase. Yeah, he's just a little too
Ryan
serious.
Ryan said that too. You're on Facebook. Somebody said if I could be serious
of
for a minute.
Of course someone did.
And
if you're going to post about it, you're going to get 80 people can I be serious for a minute?
I responded, I'm being dead serious. And everybody thought I didn't get his catchphrase. Of course I get his catchphrase, man.
But why was that your response?
Serious for a minute?
Is that supposed to be like a joke?
Do you think
joke
that
on top of a joke?
Do you think that Lance Storm is do you think that Lance Storm is being too serious?
Yes. He's taking himself too seriously, he's taking the business too seriously. It is a serious business, you take it seriously, especially if you're part of it, you love it, it's in your heart, it's in your mind. But come on, man. Now you're nitpicking. Like now you're really like making a mountain out of a molehill here. Like John Cena's bragging about like working hard in the gym, and all of a sudden that's a negative thing. Like that's bad that he's telling everybody, yeah, you should do like me and work hard in the gym. The Rock does it all the time, clanging and banging and this and that. Like you know,
right.
What's the big deal?
Lance Storm.
The Ascension thing I could see.
And here's
the Ascension thing I could see.
Right.
Because a lot of people had that reaction. It wasn't just Lance Storm.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's just kind of funny that somebody that should know better, like, because he's been handed scripts, like you said, the un-Americans. He had to say shit about America.
Right.
And
let me
he turned the TV off on himself when he's out there saying dumb shit.
He was about to burn. He was about to burn a flag.
I know.
He was going to burn a flag, the one. Listen, how many of you guys in the chat, be honest, how many of you guys have been blocked on Twitter by Lance Storm? Watch this. It's going to be about 70.
I know Punk blocks a lot of people. That's
I would
thing.
Love
CM Punk blocks everybody.
I would love to see Lance
Storm has that rep too?
Dude, he's got to have like 10,000 blocks.
I didn't know that.
He's got to have 10,000 different people blocked.
I don't even think I've added them.
Everybody.
Bam,
Storm blocked me. Lance Storm blocked me. All he does is block you. If you disagree with Lance Storm, even his opinion.
Wow, you're right. Okay.
Everybody, right?
Me.
Even his opinion. You disagree with Lance Storm's opinion, you are blocked. You're blocked. He doesn't. You disagree with him, you get blocked.
Somebody's getting blocked right now by Lance Storm. He's joking, obviously. But
you're getting blocked.
That's funny.
You get blocked by Lance Storm. I guarantee you. All right. Here we go. You want to talk about Twitter?
How much time do we got? 12 minutes? This is Josh Matthews, right?
And then we're going to do Raw for about 15, 20 minutes.
Tell the story. I'll give my opinion after I'm done pissing.
You got to pee?
They're in here, right? All right.
Yes. All right. So, check this out. Actually, let me get the plugs out of the way, and then we're going to continue back on to Twitter. Jim Ross and Josh Matthews. That's another one we need to talk about. But the official website, the official home. You guys like this new format, by the way? With all the news, we kind of do the news in hour numero uno, and then in hour numero dos, kind of do the high points and the low points of Monday Night Raw, get into your live phone calls, and rapid fire to wrap up the show. So, entire hour number one is going to be news, rumors, Boone and I kind of running things down, and then hour two, we'll do the first half hour of Monday Night Raw, kind of recap that. Second half hour of your rapid fire and live phone calls. Hopefully that's cool with you guys. If you want it done differently, let us know, man. And we do this for you guys, so it's not about us. So let us know on the feedback thread tonight if you like the new format. If not, let us know. But anyways, get to our live chat room, WZRonline.com, /chat. WZRonline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people in there, as always. Tonight, official home, official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZRonline.com. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, YouTube.com/WZRArchive. We're on Twitter as well. WZRonline.com, top navigation bar. Social media tab. It's got a drop down menu. It's got all links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube right there. WZRonline.com, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays. Live chat room once again, WZRonline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people. By the way, speaking of WZRonline.com, we got a little shout box over on the right hand side. You guys gotta let me know, man. That's been expired for like 2 months now. I had no idea. And I saw it yesterday. It said C-Box expired. And I went and renewed that for another year. So we are going to be good to go in there. All you got to do is type in your name, hit up profile, and you'll be good to go. WZRonline.com. So, let's get into, we were talking about Twitter before I did, I went to the plugs. Josh Matthews on Sunday.
Okay, it's freezing in here, you're right.
Josh Matthews on Sunday. It's always nice you take a shower right before we come on. And
then I start moving furniture.
So on Sunday, Josh Matthews comes out, and you tell me, Jim Ross sent out a tweet, something about UFC won the night.
Yeah, UFC won tonight. They didn't say they won. That's what Josh Matthews interpreted as. He interpreted it as UFC won the night in terms of they did better than the NFL tonight. Okay. And all he said was UFC, he was talking about how they promoted Conor McGregor in the show, UFC Fight Night 59, all over the NFC and the AFC championship games. They went head-to-head with the AFC. Actually, it was the NFC, not the AFC. They didn't promote it on there because that would have been Fox, right? But he was just like, yeah, UFC won.
No, the CBS had the night game. Fox
whatever,
had the early game.
But, No. Yeah, Fox had the early game. What the fuck am I saying? Fox Sports 1, of course. So they're plugging their, you know, their secondary channel, Fox Sports 1, and Conor McGregor and this and that. All he said was, you know, he addressed the fact that they promoted the fuck out of Conor and UFC on the NFL playoff game, the NFC Championship game, which was a fucking amazing game. I can't believe we didn't talk about that. But, amazing game. But, yeah, all he said was...
Seattle and Green Bay.
Yeah.
Real quick.
In Seattle.
Can you hold on to the thought for a second? Green Bay and Seattle. Green Bay had been winning the whole game. Seattle comes back.
They're
in
kicking their ass. In
their
hometown.
Seattle kicks an onside kick, recovers the onside kick, and this is after they scored a touchdown. So
is
they
this
drove
where the dude bounced the ball off his face? The
yes.
Baltic guy?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Seattle drove the entire field, right? Entire field. They go, they get a touchdown. Then they go for a two-point conversion. Russell Wilson throws the ball up just out of nowhere.
He's about to get tackled. So
sure
he's
enough.
Like, just throw it. Get it out of my head. At least somebody maybe could get it, you know, if I throw it way up
sure
in the air.
Sure enough, dude comes down with it, and they get the two-point conversion.
Now
then
the field goal only ties if they get the field goal.
Right. Then they go, and they kick an onside kick, and Seattle recovers the onside kick.
No, you did it backwards. Seattle recovered the onside kick, did the touchdown, then got the two-point conversion.
Okay.
Then they kicked it. Green Bay somehow got down the field real quick.
Right.
They only had a minute and like 8 seconds or something. They did it. Kicked the field goal. We're going to overtime.
Right.
And
go to
overtime. Yeah,
go to overtime. And then in overtime, Seattle got the ball first.
They won the coin toss. It's like just one after another, these
just
crazy good luck things.
So Russell Wilson takes a
drives
deep.
The field. Yeah.
He goes deep with a deep pass. And sure enough, they get a touchdown. They win the game.
No flags.
Seattle comes back.
Yeah.
Wins it. Green Bay just completely blew that game. And then later in the night, it was the Patriots and the
deep
Colts.
Deep late game.
Deflate gate, but listen, all right, everybody, listen.
Stupid.
Let's be honest.
So stupid.
Let's say that the balls were deflated. The final score of that game, I want to say it was 45-7. Okay, 45-7. New England manhandled the Colts. So even if the balls were deflated a
little
bit, you're
gonna bring it back to UFC. Watch
it
this.
It doesn't matter. New England destroyed them. New England outplayed them. So it's gonna be New England and Seattle. Who you got? Seattle's defending champions.
I got New England.
Seattle's defending champions.
I told you last,
okay,
before both games, I said, here's what's going to happen. Seattle is going to beat Green Bay.
Okay.
And then even when I went in his room and it was 16-0 Green Bay, I said, Seattle will still pull it off. There was still like 2.5
I'm going New England too, man. I don't want them because they're in my division.
Seattle's going to pull it off. I said, New England's going to kill the Colts, which is exactly what happened. Seattle pulled it off. New England killed the Colts. And then New England's going to fucking spank Seattle in the Super Bowl. It won't even be close. They'll fucking stick their pants down and spike their ass.
Okay.
It won't be like a blowout because Seattle's got great defense and shit like that. But it'll be. It won't be close. Put it that way.
New England's gonna win the Super Bowl, I think. You know, but
that's what I think.
I don't know.
But no. To bring it back to UFC,
I wanted to see Brady and Rodgers, Green Bay.
That would have been a fun, like a shootout kind of game.
Shootout,
yeah.
All offense. But anyway,
your Super Bowl's almost always
bring
defense.
It back to UFC.
You
for
know,
me.
Ravens, Bears. Yeah, to bring it back to the UFC, the deflate gate thing, like, oh, the balls were deflated a little bit, that's why they beat us by 18 touchdowns, you know what I mean? Like, it wasn't even close, it wasn't like, oh, this one little thing changed the course of the game.
Right.
They were spanking them the whole time. And there was a lot of things that has nothing to do, like, if you hand the ball off, does it matter if it's deflated?
No.
No! So it doesn't make a difference. So you know, and the fucking running back was kicking their ass all night for New England.
So how are you going back to UFC?
Because Conor McGregor fought Dennis Seaver in the main event on Sunday night. Instead of Saturday night, Sunday night, against the fucking game we're talking about, head-to-head.
All right.
On Fox Sports 1, which was a cable channel versus a broadcast channel, because you said CBS had the NFC Championship.
Right.
All right, but Conor McGregor fought Dennis Seaver.
CBS had the AFC. NFC was the earlier game.
No, AFC was... No, you're right. Yeah, AFC. You're right. Okay. Conor McGregor says about Dennis Seaver during all the build-up. He did more media than you've ever seen in your life. Conor McGregor did his work for this job as far as promoting the fight.
Okay.
And Dennis Seaver in the past had failed drug test. Maybe even more than one. But I know he failed drug test. And on top of failing for performance-enhancing drugs, which would tie us right into Jones, we don't have enough time. He failed.
I want to get to all of
it. He failed for masking agents, which is like, not only did he take shit that helps you cheat, he took shit to try and cheat the test so that he could cheat without getting caught cheating, if you follow what I'm saying.
Right.
Conor McGregor was saying all this stuff about how he cheats and he's going to take his fucking head off and this and that. And he said, but then, like, when they asked him, like, really, what do you think? He said, listen, he can take whatever he wants because no amount of steroids helps your chin. If I hit you on the chin.
Right.
You can take 800 pounds of steroids. If I connect on your chin, which I will, you're going down, you're getting knocked the fuck out.
Right.
Mate. You know, he said it with the Irish accent, which makes him even more of a gangster. But fucking, that's what he says. He's like,
You think somebody said, well, okay, mate. You think that makes you look like a gangster?
No, just...
You fucking gangster?
Bro, fucking... You sound just like this fucking guy.
You fucking gangster.
Yeah, man. Dude, Conor McGregor... Yo, and I bet the chat room... Anybody in the chat room that watches MMA... Like, especially religiously, because we have so many European fans.
Going to get the crumpets in the tea.
Oh, my God, they got to love Conor
McGregor.
He's a fucking rock star, bro. Are you denying he's a rock star? You want me to give you proof he's a rock star?
Conor's awesome.
You want me to give you proof? You want me to give you proof?
Yes.
Last Sunday's show.
Okay.
UFC Fight Night 59.
All right.
Biggest rating in the history of Fox Sports.
Oh, yeah?
Nothing's ever even touched it.
All right.
He beat Chael Sonnen versus Shogun in Sonnen's prime. You know what I mean? And they had a good co-main event for that one. This had Benson Henderson and Donald Cerrone.
Well, son of a bitch, mate!
Yeah, I don't know why you do the gay with the Irish, but anyway, Conor McGregor won the
gay
fight.
Thing? I didn't do a gay thing.
You did a little flip wrist kind of thing there. Son of a bitch, mate, you said.
Son of a bitch, mate!
Anyways, Conor McGregor won the fight, dominant fashion. Second round TKO, hops the cage, gets in Jose Aldo's face, the fact
that Aldo no-sold it, man.
And he fucking rah! What he always
does. No-sold it.
So that's the next fight. It's not going to be at Crook Park in Ireland, though, because there's a curfew. The whole story. We can't ever enjoy talking about MMA because I can do a fucking Roadrunner version. But it'll be in Vegas, most likely, on Memorial Day weekend. Conor McGregor, Jose Aldo for the title. In the co-main event, only other fight we need to talk about, Donald Cerrone beat Donald Cowboy Cerrone 2 weeks after he fought Miles Jury and ended Jury's undefeated streak. He beats
Dennis Seaver.
He beats... No, that was Conor McGregor. He beat Benson Henderson.
Henderson.
A guy that had beaten him twice in their previous two meetings. So he beats a guy that beat him twice after beating an undefeated guy in 2 weeks' time to make his seventh win in a row. So that motherfucker's getting a title shot this year at some point.
Kimbo Slice signed with Bellator as well.
That happened.
Talk about that real quick.
I believe it was on Friday night at their event with Pitbull Fry. Beat Strauss by choke, retained the featherweight title for the Bellator company, but during the show they announced Kimbo had signed.
Mayweather Pac-Man.
Real quick, Krokop signed with UFC. Bellator was trying to sign him.
Okay.
UFC snuck in and stole him.
Fader doesn't want to fight again. Scott Coker said that.
Exactly. Fader doesn't want to fight again. They couldn't get Gina Carano either, so they're
going to get Gina.
They're trying, you know.
Mayweather Pac-Man.
They want Del Rio. Pac-Man.
Big stuff here, right?
There was two major hang-ups back in the past. One of the major hang-ups was drug testing. Mayweather wanted Olympic-level drug testing. Mm-hmm. Pacquiao's claim was because he's Filipino, he's got a superstition that he can't have blood drawn from his body that close to a fight.
Which is
funny because Conor McGregor, Jose Aldo has a bunch of superstitions. They wanted to bring Jose Aldo into the cage.
I know.
But it's a perfect tie-in.
I know.
They wanted to bring Jose Aldo into the cage after McGregor beat Seaver on Sunday night and do the face-off. Like, remember when they did with GSP and Thiago Alves when we were in Vegas?
Aldo don't want to do it.
He says, I don't I never step in the cage unless I'm fighting. I don't want to step in that cage unless I'm fighting someone. Mm-hmm. So he wouldn't do it. That's wouldn't why McGregor hopped the fucking fence and got in his face in the crowd. He said, we're having a face-off, motherfucker, whether you like it or not.
They had Aldo later after the fight was over.
Yeah, he had a poster where he called him the Joker and stuff. But, all right, so Pac-Man Mayweather. Yeah, Pac-Man, superstition about the blood. That was one thing. And the second big holdup was the money split. I remember Roy Jones Jr. Bernard Hopkins back when they would argue with each other about a big super fight. Roy, they had a split screen interview and they're arguing about money and Roy says 70-30, I'll kick your ass. 70-30, I'll kick your ass, because he's the bigger star. He's like, give me 70%, you take 30, I'll kick your ass.
Right.
You know, because Bernard's like, oh, you're scared, I beat you. I'm blah blah blah. 70-30, I'll kick your ass. 70-30, I'll kick your ass. Fucking Mayweather wanted more than half. 50-50 split was not good enough for Mayweather. He thought he was the bigger draw. Pacquiao didn't deserve as much money. So he said either 70-30 or 60-40. Mm-hmm. Pacquiao's like, fuck you. Because at the time, he hadn't been knocked out by Marquez. He hadn't lost to Timothy Bradley yet. He was still like seen, just like Mayweather, as like unbeatable.
Right.
Then he loses a couple fights. Now he's saying, all right, I'll do 60-40. I'll take 40%. You take 60.
Makes sense.
We'll do it in May. Money Mayweather. You like to fight in May all the time. So they go to Mayo always. He says, I'll do it. But I just read today before we went on the air, he set a deadline. He says, if Mayweather doesn't sign the bout agreement before the end of January, I got to find another opponent because I'm fighting in May, too. So we might have a May showdown between a Mayweather fight on Showtime
and
a Pacquiao fight on HBO.
It could be.
You know, so we'll have the all-access versus 24/7 treatment. It would be kind of interesting either way.
It would be good. And you know what? I mean, Pacquiao's lost his last couple of fights, right? I mean, one of them was a shitty,
he's won his last couple of fights, but lost
there were a couple before that. Right.
They tried to make this fight originally.
One of them was a real shitty decision or a real
Timothy Bradley never beat him. Yeah, yeah.
All right, so there was that. So basically, Pacquiao agrees, all right, 60-40 split.
And he rematched.
That bad.
Beat him, by the way.
Right,
He had a rematch and he won.
Listen, a 60-40 split, they're going to make millions off that fight. Everybody wants to see that fight.
You're going
to
give Mayweather he made $72 million off of one fight not too long ago. I think it was the Canelo Alvarez fight where they did like record pay-per-view.
Imagine Pacquiao Mayweather, dude. That's all we got to say.
He'll get 70 to 80 all million. Right. Pacquiao get 20, 30 million. That's plenty. Fight each other.
All right, 2 minutes before we got to go to the commercial break. Real quick bits, and then I want to come back. I want to talk Josh Matthews, Jim
Ross.
Call
me real quick bitch or real quick bits?
I said real quick news bits.
Okay. Yeah. I thought you said real quick bitch.
I want to save Josh Matthews and Jim Ross until we come back from the commercial break. I already talked about Lance Storm. Eva Marie, the reason she is out of action right now is due to a popped breast implant. So she's out of action due to that. Nikki Bella, strained hamstring.
What's his name on Total Divas?
Not going to be out.
Yeah.
Jonathan.
How the fuck did you do that? I couldn't even think of it. I watch every show.
So she is out with a popped breast implant.
J. Cole.
There you go. Nikki Bella, strained hamstring. Not going to be out long. It's only
strained. She missed the weekend this past week.
It's only strained, so that's not going to be. Goldberg and Beth Phoenix doing a lot of media as of late, especially Bill Goldberg. Bill Goldberg thinks that CM Punk could be something in UFC. He knows that he's an excellent trainer.
Did you see
the
background stuff about Punk?
I did not.
Yeah,
but
it's not worth
Bill Goldberg, they've been asking him, would you ever return to WWE? He is,
he's got conditions, but he'll
he's
come back.
He's got conditions, but you know, he wasn't a big fan of the way that he was used last time.
He
was used like shit. Yeah. But he is open to a WWE return. Same thing with Beth Phoenix, who is now married, I believe, to Edge. Married or girlfriend?
I thought they broke up.
They're still together.
They're still together.
But I don't know if it's boyfriend, girlfriend, or if they're married.
That's a big bitch. Wow. Jesus Christ. Have you ever seen her without... Talk about without makeup.
Without makeup, yeah.
Not only is it like, oh, well, her body's so great that you can look past the face. Like, no. Her body's manly, and her face is...
The other thing I want to save is Vince McMahon and MLK. Vince McMahon called Martin Luther King Jr. his hero.
Did you see the video package last night?
Fuck out of it. I saw the
video. That was one of the longest MLK video packages.
Alberto Del Rio recently signed with Lucha Underground, debuted at the TV tapings on Friday night. TNA offered him a six-figure deal. He turned down that offer, and according to reports, talked to a lot of friends, and a lot of people are telling him that TNA is a career killer. Career ender, and he opted not to sign with TNA. So, he is under contract right now with Ring of Honor and Lucha Underground.
He made Ring of Honor debuted
at the
And Bellator is offering him a seven-figure deal.
Seven-figure deal.
And he might have turned it down from what I've heard.
Really?
I think so.
All right.
Glory, I think, even offering him a big-ass deal. Kickboxing company. He ain't no fucking kickboxer.
Two things I want to talk about. McMahon and Martin Luther King.
McMahon, Martin Luther King, McMahon, there's all these rumors about black men being world champions in WWE. There hasn't been many.
Until The Rock, there was never one.
Until Mark Henry and
The Rock was the one, the first one. And then after
not many. So
after that, it was, Mark Henry. Can you count any others? I can't even think of any others.
I can't think
of
any
others. I'm sure there's a few others.
So is Martin Luther King really Vince McMahon's hero? Or was it MLK Day, Vince McMahon, public figure, said, this is my
hero. He's trying to get media.
He's trying to get media.
Oh, shit.
And then they do a big old video package. Yeah. Do you believe Vince McMahon from yesterday? We're going to talk about that when we come back from the break. And
you have a whole thing on that, huh?
And Josh Matthews. Josh Matthews, a young cat in the business, all of a sudden...
He's not young anymore.
Lands at TNA's...
30s.
30s? Yeah. He's still pretty fucking young.
15 years ago.
Comes out on Sunday and says to Jim Ross, you're an old man, shut up. Oh, where did this come from?
No, he said, you're an old man, shut up. Anybody over 60 needs to just go away, is what he said.
Go away?
Let's save it. You're right.
This guy gets a TNA announcing deal, and all of a sudden this dude...
Toilets him.
King shit. Josh Matthews?
I think he's scared JR is negotiating with TNA, and he's going to come take his job.
Who are you?
Like, oh, shit.
Funkmaster Flex and Jay-Z. Jay-Z about to buy Hot 97. Funkmaster
Flex. I didn't even hear about that, really?
Funkmaster Flex goes on a rant the other day and says, fuck you, Jay. I'm the king of New York. You ain't the king of New York. And he says, if you decide to go out and trash me on a record, I will come on this radio station every day and I will trash you. Real New Yorkers know who...
He doesn't need to sell it. Jay-Z could live the rest of his life off his fucking... his interest.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
Jay-Z and Beyonce combined. They're a power Billions. Couple.
Billions.
900 million.
Billions.
900 million.
That's probably what they can report. I guarantee you there's money they ain't reporting.
As a combined couple.
Yeah, of what the government knows about. Can you imagine how much millions of dollars of shit that they're not reporting to the government? Come on.
You're listening to WZR TV Tuesdays with Matt Boone
and
Ryan Clark. Into our live chat room, WZROnline.com. We also want your rapid fire questions. Go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. You can submit your rapid fire questions. Any rapid fire question, one line only. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Top post up there. We're asking you for your rapid fire questions. Again, one line only. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. For me, boo. This is Ryan Clark. And see you in a couple of minutes. For our numero dos. Go on, mate. Let me tell you. Two things.
Number one.
Boone just told me. It's hard to be my friend these days. Number two, can you turn the music down for me? Boone said it's hard to be a friend. Number two, so POTUS comes out during the commercial break.
And he quizzes me and I didn't know who the fuck
So I said to him, alright, POTUS is up in the front. You got OB up in the front.
Yeah.
And I said to him, there's two guys sitting to the back of him. On the right-hand side is a guy.
I knew when you gave me the initials.
And I said, who's the guy on the right-hand side? And you said, I don't know. I said, dude.
He's the vice president.
I said, it's the vice president of the United States.
Yeah.
I said, let me give you a hint. JB.
And then I got it.
I said, not Justin Bieber. JB. You thought about it?
I
said, okay. I said, Joe.
Yeah.
You said Joe Biden.
I didn't do all that stuff. I knew Biden right when you
said
Joe.
To the other, I said to him again, I said, who's the other guy?
That one I didn't know.
On the left-hand side. Once again, I said, JB. And I didn't know that.
And I said, Jeremy Boring.
JB.
Jack Black.
And JB.
Oh. Peanut butter and jelly.
Did
what?
You know that?
What?
JB and JB sitting behind Obama.
Until you said it.
So I said once again, JB. I said, who's that guy? I said, he said, I don't know that one. I said, John Boehner. John Boehner. I can't believe
it.
You don't know
I knew the name Joe Boehner
Biden
said it.
And
you
John
said it, I knew
Boehner
it.
Are?
You tell me his position and his initials. I don't know the Secretary of State. I don't give a fuck. I've never voted in my life. Ever. Not once. Have you voted for the president ever?
Yes.
When?
I voted for the president.
When?
Not last year, but the year before.
Oh, when I wasn't here, yeah. Last year I did because you were here, and you would have saw it, and you could say it's full of shit right now on the camera. But the year before that, when you weren't here, and you can't say that I'm lying because you don't know anything.
You should all vote.
I voted then. Yeah. How about the fucking 3 years I lived here before that? I didn't see you vote any of those years, scumbag. And that was like one of the years where everybody in New York was all like, what was that one fucker's name? Everybody was behind him. Yeah. He raced against Bush the second time.
Huckabee.
No. That was the guy that said, yeah, right? That was Huckabee, right?
No, that was the guy from Texas. Romney.
Mitt Romney. That's who everybody wanted, right? No. That was Mitt Romney who did. Remember the guy that freaked out and said, yeah! He was like a pastor. He was like nuts and stuff.
Jesus, who was that? It was last year, man. It was Mitt Romney.
It was years ago.
It was when they were, not last year, but it was when they were running against Obama.
John Kerry's who I'm thinking of, by the way.
Well, that's everybody not him.
No, the guy I'm thinking of that everybody in New York was behind the last time I lived here was John Kerry, because I had a bunch of friends at the time.
Well, he's not the guy that squirts out,
I've never voted. I'm going to register vote. I'm going to sign up and vote for John Kerry.
Howard Dean. He said, and I'm going through Texas, and I'm going through and I'm going through New York, and I'm going through Virginia,
and
I'm going
to Washington,
D.C. Yeah!
Years and years ago.
Yeah,
somebody Google it and tell me. It was probably 8 years ago.
Wait a minute. President Obama is now in his second term of office.
Correct.
So it had to have been.
Nothing to do with Obama.
Yes, it did.
No, this was Bush days.
They were on the campaign
trail.
It was about 6 years ago. If Obama is in his second term,
maybe 6 years.
It was the guys that were running against Obama.
Maybe.
It was the guys that were running against him. So it was 6 or 7 years ago. Obama's got what? One or two more years? He's got 2 years left?
I believe so.
All right. Because it's 4 years then another 4 years. So it was probably 5 years. 5 or 6 years ago? I'm thinking that was, because it was the guys that were, it was Howard Dean.
You're letting us down. Somebody checked years ago.
When he was running against Obama, it was probably about 5 or 6 years ago.
2004. That was 11 years ago, you stupid son of a bitch. Apologize to me. On air, on camera, apologize to me.
No.
11 years ago.
Howard Dean was running against Obama, not Bush.
Bush.
No.
Bush.
No, I don't think so.
Bush.
Dean was running against Obama, not.
This was back when I watched the Howard Stern show, or listened to it every day, because Artie was still on the show. He's got a new show called the Artie Quitter Podcast. I listen to that now.
I'm going
to
say it was 7 years ago. 7 years ago.
2004. During the primary.
I don't believe him.
2004 during the primary. He's right. I guarantee you Google it, he's right, because that sounds right to me, and I know he's right.
Howard Dean, when he went, yeah! Somebody Google that. It was about 2007.
Bush.
That's the same guy.
Yeah?
It's the same guy that...
Boone is right.
No, he's wrong.
Still the same guy saying all this, but I believe him. I think he's right.
I think it was about 2007 or
2008. Yeah, Obama ran against McCain, but no, I know what he's saying. Huckabee was like the third guy running, right?
Yeah.
Even in Bush's time, it was Bush, McCary... And then there was
Howard Dean and Obama are Democrats. They're both Democrats.
So that couldn't have been. Fuck. There you go. Right. Now he's got his proof. Yeah. Only one guy's running Democratic.
Anyway.
There you go. Rygal. 2004, 100%.
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
All right.
Apologize.
I'm sorry.
You're wrong.
I'm sorry.
Who was wrong? Who was right?
You were right. I was wrong.
We should keep a tab of how many times he's had to say that on the air. It's astonishing. I've told him off air. Have I not told you this off air? Yo, if I'm really sure about something...
You weren't really sure about
that. No, I was really
asking people in the chat.
No, I was really sure that it was more than whatever you said.
This
is
coming from the guy that can't tell me who the Vice President of the United States is.
I admit that.
The Vice President of the United States is on the fucking television, and this guy can't tell me who the Vice President is.
This is what I deal with, guys. He doesn't understand the difference. I didn't sit here and say, I know who the vice president is. I just said I didn't fucking know who he was.
Unbelievable.
But if we're in an argument and we're waiting on facts, you should just assume I'm right if I'm passionate. Because I won't be passionate because I don't want to look stupid unless
you're
I know I'm right.
Hey.
I was passionate.
So what? Josh Matthews.
That's a story right there.
Josh Matthews, bro. What do you think about Josh?
Well, first of all, tell people the story, and then...
Story is, we told them before we went to the commercial break.
We didn't really give the whole thing.
Well, it was on Sunday, and you had said that Josh
Saturday
Matthews,
night, actually. It was like midnight.
That was on Sunday.
Cause oh, no, you're right. It was the fight night. Yeah, Sunday.
Who was
I'm
right?
So used to it being
who
Saturday.
Was right?
You're right, I was wrong.
Woo!
We didn't argue for 10 minutes before we came to that. It was 2 seconds.
All right, so listen. Basically, so, I mean, you told him the story before we went to the break, bro. It was basically Josh Matthews
the
came out.
There were some good
he
quotes.
Said that UFC won the night. And
won tonight.
And Josh came out and basically said, listen, you're 60 years old. Once you turn 60, nobody cares about your opinion. You shouldn't comment.
It was a misunderstanding
like
because Josh Matthews thought that Jim Ross was saying UFC outperformed the NFL tonight. And
right.
Matthews was this like, are you fucking stupid? The NFL probably had 80 billion people watching. UFC had 2 million, and you'd say they win?
Yeah.
All Jim Ross meant was UFC wins tonight, meaning, like, they did a good job.
They had the better fights and the better
games.
No.
They're not even saying he beat the NFL. He's just saying UFC won tonight, meaning they did a good job promoting their show tonight. They're not even saying they did better than the NFL. He said, yo, UFC won tonight after doing all these plugs on
see,
NFL.
I didn't take it like that.
That's what
I
he
didn't
meant.
Take it like that.
He,
all right.
He said it, no, he in one of his follow-ups to, to Josh Matthews.
All right.
He explained himself, and he said, no, and when I read it, and then I went back and said, let's see if Jim Ross is just covering his tracks. I read the initial one, and Jim Ross did not say anything even
right, I took
sort
it,
of close to, we beat the UFC.
I took it like this. I took it like this, that
the like,
NFL
we won tonight because we did a good job piggybacking off the NFL.
I took it like this, that the NFL game turned out to be a complete blowout, 45-7, and the UFC.
I could see how you'd go
the
there.
UFC
had
some pretty fucking good fights on tonight. They were pretty good. Not necessarily the co-main event and the main event,
but
the NFL game was so goddamn boring. Even
the
though it was a playoff game, the second
the first one was amazing.
The Patriots
we were fucking jumping up and down and screaming like
the Patriots Colts game.
Yeah, that
was
boring.
You know, and I figured that Jim Ross was saying, well, that was so boring that a lot of NFL fans probably switched over and watched the UFC. So in that respect, in that regard, in that regard, you know, the NFL fans tuned over to check out UFC, and UFC won the night because the NFL game was so boring.
You know,
that's
what
I did.
He might have had a little subtle.
Whatever the case may be.
Basically, all he
Josh
said was UFC won the night because they did a great job of using the NFL to get everybody to watch their show. That's basically
Josh Matthews comes
and
out.
And
I'm just thinking, Josh Matthews. We know what Matthews said. I mean, we talked about it couple of times now.
He's,
but
anybody over 60 needs to
Jim
go away.
Ross,
it was clearly drunk tweeting.
Jim Ross.
You gotta understand, too.
Vince McMahon,
for those
Jesse
who don't know,
Ventura,
this was like,
Bobby Heenan paved the way for guys
that's not even
like
relevant.
Josh Matthews.
Real quick. So it was at about 1 a.m.,
okay.
These tweets.
And you're thinking...
You tell me what's going on. Football, fights,
football,
they're not drinking a couple beers,
fights.
Watching the fights and the football.
I'm thinking Josh Matthews got a little bit drunk.
We got into a fight on fucking Sunday night, you know what I mean?
You and I were arguing over... With my sister.
Yeah.
But listen, so... And granted, to Josh's credit, yesterday he came out and I put the apology up on the website. Josh did come out and apologize to Jim.
Because he's sobered
that
up.
Because
he's
sober.
He woke
up
and felt stupid.
Because he's sober.
And I guarantee he woke up and he had a billion tweets. Like, when you were dead for the weekend and everybody was tweeting you like crazy, like a big frenzy of tweets all of a sudden. You're like, what is all this? And then you see it and you're like, oh, rest in peace, rest in peace.
Josh had one tweet.
By the way, if you were dead, all these people tweeting you, how are you ever going to read those tweets? Why would they
well, I responded to a lot of them and said I'm
but if you were actually dead, like, why would they, like, let's say that they...
I said I'm sorry to disappoint a lot of you guys, because there's a lot of people out there that...
But if someone dies, why would you tweet them? They can't read, like, if Ultimate Warrior, when he died, did everybody tweet Ultimate Warrior? Oh, rest in peace, Warrior. I'm sure they did, but, like,
you know what freaks
who's
going to
read it?
You know what freaks me out is
people
the Ultimate, Warrior, like, I'll be on my feed, on my Twitter feed, and there'll be tweets from the Ultimate Warrior. Like, somebody's on his account tweeting, order my
promoting
DVD,
shit.
Order my DVD, do this, and I
still got the audience, I would use it too, shit.
It's probably his wife or management team or somebody like that that's doing
publicist.
It, but it's like, man, it's the Ultimate Warrior that's tweeting on my
feed. You gotta remember, a lot of these famous people don't even do their own tweets.
I know,
it's
I
their
know.
Publicist.
It's their publicist and the
either one of two things
else.
Happens. The
right.
publicist will write the tweets for the artist, or... the artist will tell the publicist, say what this.
Right.
Or the publicist will type it and check with
the artist
and say, does this sound good? And they'll either say, yeah, go ahead and post that, or
do
no.
Do you think that Kim Kardashian and people like that, do you think that they're sending those tweets
not
out?
Not all of them.
Fuck no. Not all
maybe
of them.
Maybe every once in
maybe
a while.
Maybe a couple of photos and things like that. There's a few of them that they've got it hooked up to their telephone. But all the products, you know, check out this website and go here and order this product. That's not Kim Kardashian or whoever it is tweeting that. It's their management team and their publicist.
But yeah, to the Josh Matthews.
But what do you think about Josh?
I mean, he was a total dickhead.
He was a dick, but
yeah,
I think we both agree that, listen, one too many on Sunday, woke up on Monday,
regretted
issued an apology, sent out an apology.
Damage is done. Everybody will look at Josh Matthews differently from now on. They
you know
say,
what?
That little ungrateful prick.
Here's the deal.
You know?
And it happens with you and I all the time.
Okay.
When you are drunk,
yes.
When you get drunk, your real feelings come out. How you're really feeling.
That's what they say. The real person comes out when you're
drunk. The real person comes out when you're drunk. So, Josh Matthews, when he sent out those tweets.
He clearly doesn't like Jim Ross.
Let's assume that. Yeah. Matthews
there might have even been an incident in the past, like Jim Ross, because Josh Matthews was part of the announcement team, so he probably worked with JR a few times, and maybe JR was like a dick to him, and JR has a history of being like a dick to
people.
Kind
of a dick, right.
Like an egotistical kind of like, just Heyman would even say when Heyman, who had announcing experience, and obviously television experience as a manager, when Jerry Lawler quit in protest of his wife, the cat, being fired, Miss Kitty, when Heyman took over for him, Heyman, and they even had the audio of it on Heyman's DVD. Heyman sits down and JR says, "All right, kid, just follow me. We'll be all right. Don't worry about it, kid. Just follow me. We'll be just fine." You know, like Heyman. If I'm Heyman, I'm like, asshole. I've done announcing before,
right?
In WCW, in ECW,
right?
Motherfucker, we've worked before. Heyman and JR worked together in WCW. That's where Heyman got his start as an announcer,
right?
While he was doing the manager thing too.
You go back to
dangerously.
You go back to Vince McMahon, Jesse Ventura, Bobby Heenan, people like that that paved the way for guys like Josh Matthews. And sometimes it's better to stay off Twitter and Facebook and social media in general when you have a couple beers. I've learned that.
Yeah.
My whole Lance
Storm. You haven't
learned that. My whole Lance Storm thing where I, you know, went and said
Jabba
this, that. I woke up the next morning and I said, you know what, dude, that was kind of fucking stupid for me to do. And
you could pretty much say every Twitter war you've ever been in probably started with you saying something dumb.
No, there's been some
that you really felt, but that you didn't have the balls to say it until you drank eight beers, and you're like, let me tell this Taz, this fucking commentary sucks. And then Taz says, "You live in New York, I'm going to kill you, motherfucker." And then Ryan says, "Oh, you know what, you're all right." You know?
Monday Night Raw from last night. Vince McMahon, MLK. If we have time for it, we'll come back later, because it's not a big deal. All right, so Monday Night Raw, it was billed up as a Raw reunion show for last night, right? We had the NWO came back, we had Hogan on there.
DX.
Yeah, Hogan was out there. God,
well, backstage.
They do this panel thing. Oh, my God, dude. You've got Ric Flair, Shawn Michaels, and Hulk Hogan. All right, listen. They opened up Monday Night Raw, right? And
also the Royal Rumble Go-Home Show, which always...
We got to do this quick.
It boggles my mind.
Please,
why do they do these themed shows on the final show before especially a big pay, your second biggest show of the year, essentially.
Right.
And you're going to do this big theme where the focus is going to be all fucked up because...
Right.
A lot of people are going to be like, which legends are coming back? What are they going to do with them? Not like, oh, who's going to do this before the Rumble this Sunday? Nobody's even thinking like that.
Right. We have Paul Heyman and Brock Lesnar rushed out to the ring, right?
I thought it was a good opener.
It was a really good opener.
Yeah. Long story short, Brock Lesnar was pissed because he got curb stomped by Seth Rollins after suplexing first. So he wanted answers, he wanted explanations, or he wanted the fight. Mm-hmm. And long story short, everybody came out.
Triple H was out there, dude. Stephanie
came out with Big Show and Kane when Brock was about to fucking... Cena comes out, Rollins appears on the big screen, like, everybody's mixing it up. They set up things for tonight, this big poll around Cena.
Right,
fans, we're going to let you guys decide whether he's lost it or not, kind of thing. And
does he fight tonight? There's going to be a match tonight.
We don't know who against.
It's going to be John Cena against Seth Rollins.
Oh, we don't know who against.
Oh, we didn't know what this
was.
No, you're right.
We just said, would you like a chance to get your three friends their jobs back? Well, if you win your match tonight. Because Cena said, How about this? If I win the title this Sunday at the Rumble, you rehire my friends.
And right.
I'll do you one better. I'll give you a match tonight. If you win that, they're hired.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly.
And then, of course, it was a 3-on-1 handicap.
Now, we didn't know the stipulations at this point, right, with Triple H and Steph were going to be ringside, or they did announce that.
No.
But we didn't know
the
opponent.
I think he said that they would be there to watch it. They didn't say who his opponents would be, though.
All right. We had Bray Wyatt and...
He announced those with the drum roll later in the show, remember?
Right. With the guy. All right, we had Bray Wyatt and Daniel Bryan. God, I gotta tell you what.
What the fuck was that?
Daniel Bryan, right? Every time Daniel...
He lost his first match on Raw in months!
But it's like, Triple H, when Triple H comes back from a torn quad, they're trying to make Bray Wyatt look so strong with the Undertaker rumors.
That's why,
he's beaten Dean Ambrose, he defeats Daniel Bryan, he's defeated, you know, all these guys, dude, where they're trying to make
him look
strong.
Well, he didn't get an entrance. He got the fucking jobber treatment. But listen, come back from commercial, he's already in the ring.
When Triple H came back from his torn quad, right, you're so nervous to see him wrestle.
Yeah.
And it's like every spot, it's the same
thing. Anything with his legs, like,
it's
oh,
the same
fuck,
thing
do that.
With Daniel Bryan. Randy Orton with his neck, where somebody pulls up, they got him on the ground, and they pull up on his neck, and you're like, his neck
and
his
fucking
neck,
Bryan's
neck.
Diving through the rope.
Oh my god.
Oh, fucking
it's the
this.
Same thing with Daniel Bryan, right?
Changed.
Somebody's got Daniel Bryan's, you know, his arm behind his back, and you're thinking, please don't fucking hurt it. You know
what I mean? That I wouldn't think, because that's a worked thing. Like, but what you can't control is when you dive fucking over the rope.
But even one
how
wrong
you land,
move,
you can't control that. You know,
even
your neck's the thing, not
even
your arm.
One
your
wrong
arm's
move
having effects because of your neck.
You know how stiff they work. Where if I were to take your arm and I'm
yeah, no, they're snug about it.
But
it's not
a little thing up there
that you
know?
Be careful about. You can't be careful how you fly over the rope. There's no way to be careful doing that. You land how you land.
Right.
Hopefully the guy catches you and you don't really twist or bang anything. That, you know.
So Bryan loses.
Loses clean.
Lost clean.
Well, no, Kane distracted him, I think, and then Kane beat him down after the match, right? Kane came out during the match, even with his music and everything, and sat at ringside. We went to commercial. Actually, two commercials.
You're right. Kane came out, interference,
and... yeah, and then after the match, he chokes, you know, he beat the fuck out of him some more. So we're going to the Kane-Daniel Bryan
first team. Time backstage, we had Kevin Nash, Scott Hall, right? They're in their NWO shirts. They walk into
Triple H's
office, right? They said, what happened to you, bro? Like, what are you doing?
What is this? Yeah.
You know? X-Pac.
Shawn Michaels
walks in.
Triple H makes fun of his shirt. He had some kind of weird shirt on. And then all of a sudden, X-Pac just...
Yeah,
suck it. That's all he does when he comes in, and it looked just like him.
When I first said, did you know, before I yelled it, I don't think you did, because I looked at it, and it looked like, it looked like Walton at first. And then I looked for a minute, and I yelled into you, I said, yo, it's Sandow.
No, by then I understand, it was obvious. By the time you said that, it was obvious.
So anyways,
when he first came in, for the first, I'd say, two full seconds, I'm looking at him doing that, I'm like, all right, here we go. Where are they going with
it
this?
Was
next
good.
Thing you know, the real other X-Pac, and we've got two X-Pacs face-to-face, and I'm like, oh, shit, who, oh, it's, yeah, okay.
Well,
the real
X-Pac, please stand up.
There you go.
Stand up.
Hopefully, he'll be standing up on the air here
in
a couple weeks.
Yeah. So he comes in, right, and they hype that the NWO is going to be here later tonight. They're coming to the ring, this, that, and the other
the
thing.
The click.
This is where...
That was the click. Nash,
that
Paul,
was the click.
Waltman,
that was
Michaels,
the click.
Hunter. That's the click.
So then, we've got a Legends panel, right? And they did a Legends panel, and I think it was the same guys. It was Hogan.
No, it was Hogan, Flair, and Michaels.
And Michaels.
Well, Byron Saxon hosting.
Okay,
Big
and
came out
the last time they did the Legends panel...
Oh, I don't remember. No, so you were just like Charlotte. Charlotte thought, and I'm still trying to say Shaley.
It wasn't as bad as the last one.
No, I'm going a different direction.
Okay.
I thought it was going to be not for the live crowd. They were going to be sitting at a table up in the arena somewhere talking to the camera with Renee Young sitting there asking them for their predictions and shit. Like
Dinner
in-between thing. That's why when I'm talking to you and Charlotte, I'm like, yo, that's what they're going to, they fly Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair, Shawn Michaels, into this big show, and all they're gonna do is have them give predictions for fake fights on a fucking table in the middle of the arena.
You know it was gonna be in the ring.
I did not know it was gonna be in the ring.
They've done this before.
Once. And then how many other panels have they done at a table way up in the fucking building somewhere? For the camera, but not for the crowd.
They do that for the
all the time.
Not just
the pre-shows.
For the pay-per-view
shows. A million times.
They have?
Yes.
When have they ever shot? When have they ever shot?
A million times.
To a panel live on Raw that are sitting in it. Right.
Roll with it, brother. I'm telling you, a million times they've done that.
Tell me when.
Booker's been part of them. Flair's been part of them. Michaels has been part of them. Renee Young usually hosts it. Or another one.
I'll pull up the chat room. I see that. Listen, every time on pay-per-views, we get the pre-show, and then during the show, they cut in, and you've got Booker T, Alex Ryan, people like that. But on Monday Night Raw, they don't have a panel. There's no panel that's
had
in a skybox.
Yes.
When?
They've done it once or twice. I remember Flair.
I know the pay-per-views, they do it all the time.
No, they do that all the time with
Flair
the
Flair was just at a recent pay-per-view, a couple recent pay-per-views. Flair's been in.
What about Raw?
I don't remember.
It's the pre-show setup, yeah, what Rygal's saying. The pre-show setup, where the table is, they will have had guys that are part of the pre-show. They'll shoot to them during the show, and I guess it's not considered a panel. It's here's the guys from the Raw pre-show, and, you know, big names has been part of that. But it's
on Monday Night Raw.
Yes.
I haven't seen this on Raw in can't tell you how long.
See, you thought, so, Boone's right. There you go.
You guys tell me when the last...
You don't trust him?
No, I do, but when is
the
last
John
Raw?
Morgan. They did it during the initial few weeks of the WWE Network, Clark. It's a panel discussion during the pre-show, and then, they shoot back to it during
the show. I get
the
pre-show.
Yeah.
Listen, guys,
shoot,
I get
they
the
shoot pre- back to it during
I get
the show.
The pre-show, I get the pay-per-views, I get that they do a panel, you've got Booker T, you've got Alex Riley.
Heyman's been part of it a few times during the show.
Let's do that. So that's the Raw pre-show, that's the pay-per-views, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about live on Monday Night Raw, the USA Network.
Yes,
okay,
correct.
Every Monday night I watch.
Correct.
And I have not seen a panel on Raw.
Oh, you missed it.
Skip the pay-per-views.
A couple times it's happened.
Skip the pre-show. Yep. Live on Raw, 3 hours Monday night. When is the last time you have seen a panel of guys live from 8 to 11:05 Eastern Time Monday night? When's the last time you've seen a panel on
Raw? They don't
do
it often. They have done it, yes.
I haven't seen it in...
And I'll be honest.
You said they do
it
all the time.
No, I didn't. I said they've done it multiple times.
All right.
And they have. I can picture Heyman being part of it. I can picture Flair being part of it.
I can't.
Sitting there in the balcony.
I can't remember the last time they've done it.
With Renee Young asking them questions. Only their questions get heard loud to the arena. But they're not in the ring, and they're not really performing for the crowd. They're performing
for the
camera.
You watch the Raw pre-show every week, pretty much.
Yeah.
Are you sure you're not mistaken the Raw pre-show? Because I know what happens on the pre-show, but not live on Raw.
You got to give me enough credit for being able to distinguish the difference between what's before the show and what's during the show. It's happened during the show.
I watch Raw.
There's a couple people in here that are agreeing with you, by the way.
I watch Raw every week, and I don't see any panel whatsoever, whether it be in the Skybox or...
All right.
We'll move on. We had,
I'll be honest, there was a couple chat rooms that thought I was dumb and wrong and this and that.
You may be right.
And
I
they
know
keep,
that they do it
and
for
what's
the
funny is because they've got a great argument. No, you're thinking of the pre-shows on the pay-per-views, the pre-shows for all the post-shows. No, I'm not. I know those two.
Live during Raw.
Live during Raw.
I can't
couple
picture.
Times.
I can't.
And that's
picture.
What I thought this was going to be, this Legends panel. And I'm like, what a fucking waste of all these guys. And then when we came back from commercial and I saw the red carpet and the chairs... Which they've done before that too,
right.
With the same guys, I think. Like you said, I know it was Hogan and Flair, and then maybe it was Michaels too.
Well, they had the segment that they did last night. They've had before, and I think it was
once,
the same guys.
I believe
one time.
Yeah, the panel I'm talking about, which has been on Raw more than once.
See,
I'd say two or three times at least. But Heyman, I can picture specifically because he would
not any time recently.
As soon as he would talk, the crowd would all boo. So I guess they had the mic loud enough that the crowd could hear it. I'm telling you.
What did you think of the panel last night on Raw? I mean, they were out there talking about the Rumble. Well, who do you think is going to win? Oh, I think Cena's going to win. I think Rollins is going to win. Well, I think
what
Cena's
was funny was
win.
The very first question that was asked to them, each of them had a one-word answer. It was yes. Or maybe two. Yes, brother, or no,
did
brother.
Did they come across as just corny? Like, you've got three legends in the ring.
At first.
Now, last night, it came across as pretty fucking good.
It got good.
Much
it got
better.
Good.
It was much better than the previous one. Yeah, I agree.
Look at me. What am I doing?
God, remember what happened?
Am I bringing fireworks?
Remember what happened? Thank God Jim Ross wasn't there.
Yeah.
God, I'm surprised. I'm surprised Byron Saxton still got a job today, right, dude? Jesus, last time Ric Flair was drunk, Jim Ross is on stage with him, and Jim Ross gets fired.
It's
Byron Saxton.
It's
in the same position.
No, not the same position. It's different when you're in front of 20,000 people and you're on live television. Flair can get crazy, but he knows, like, yo, I got to shut up eventually or I'm going to get in real fucking trouble here.
Right.
You know.
Flair, you know, there was one point where, and this went on for about 2 minutes straight,
And Flair's going like this on the ropes. He's going back and forth. Back and forth. And he's bouncing off the ropes. And I thought it was just going to be like a little 5 or 10 second thing. They kept shooting back with the
maybe
camera.
Maybe because he was stretching.
And Flair's going like this off the ropes. And I'm like, what
during the
doing?
Segment when Big Show came out, he went up, chopped him, punch. And
right.
Then he hit the ropes and he was, and boom, walked through a knockout punch. So maybe he was making sure that his back was, because you know, hitting ropes doesn't feel good.
No.
Especially if you're old. No offense, Mr. fucking legend, God.
But this went on for like 2 minutes where he's back and forth. And every camera shot him like, he's still going.
Yeah.
He's still doing this, man.
I caught that.
What the fuck is going on here? Anyways.
It turned out to be a good segment.
It turned out to be all right.
Big Show came out and threatened all of them. And then then he hit Ric Flair, like I said.
Right.
Big Show went too far with talking shit to him.
Right.
Flair took his coat off because he's the only one that can work.
Right.
I guess Shawn Michaels could. They just didn't have to do it. He chopped him. Hits the ropes. Knockout punch. And then... And then out comes Roman Reigns. And
wasn't that the APA's thing?
It sounded very close, right?
All right.
It's pretty similar thing.
The APA,
pretty similar thing.
They came out later.
If you think about the beat of it, it's pretty similar. It's a Delta Shield Hell, so I got to pour it. But so Reigns comes through the crowd, which if it was a real fight, Big Show could have fucking killed all of them by the time it took him to get to the ring. He's starting at the top of a 20,000 seat building. He's taking all the way down.
Right.
Like if it was a shoot, he could have beat all those old motherfuckers' asses, and then by the time Reigns get there, he's like, oh, fuck, I'm sorry.
My bad.
But instead, it's pro wrestling. So he came down, clotheslined him over the top, Big Show was selling his arm.
Right.
Backed off, and yeah, so they gave Reigns the rub from the Legends.
What else do we want to talk about? Right, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
The pole.
God, I want to talk about that later with the Ascension, man. You want to talk about
that? Was the other big legend
getting
thing.
The rub from the legends?
Yeah, yeah.
Good lord! All right, we have Bad News Barrett.
That's where it's the pole results.
Oh, John Cena obviously won
Triple
the pole.
Triple H basically posed it in the opener. I know, but
I know.
That we're gonna find out what the WWE Universe thinks, but it's worth addressing because this was their thing. Like, let's see how many people are behind Cena still,
right,
and how many aren't.
A lot of people were.
I don't know, it was 85% no, and 75% or 15% yes, or the other way around. Whatever.
The other way around, in favor of Cena.
Of the match.
No,
it was in favor of the match, which means they were in favor of Cena risking not being in the fucking Rumble match on Sunday.
Right, and that was the poll all along.
Yeah.
Right.
But it was a spin, which nobody's mentioned this yet, and that's why I wanted to talk about this. They had themselves covered either way. Because let's say 85% said, yes, we want him to risk his ass and his title shot to get his friends his jobs back.
And that's what happened.
Exactly, that's what happened. And the promo spin is, well, these guys want to see these three get their job back, and they believe in me so much that that's why they voted yes.
Okay.
If it had been no, they don't want me to risk my title shot on Sunday because they want me to see me beat up Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins. So either way, he can cut a promo to where... oh, the fans did that because they want me to do this.
It's John Cena. You knew the poll was coming out yes either way. It's John Cena.
I know, but I'm just saying. They covered their asses. Like, it was a simple yes or no. There's no way to really bury him because he can... and they had the promo segment, which they even built up before it happened. They showed him standing with Renee before the Legends panel, like, getting ready.
Right.
After the Legends panel, we shot to them. So, like, it was, like, a really hyped up thing. That's
why
I thought we should address.
You knew they were voting yes anyway, because it's a John Cena poll. The fired guys come in.
Well, it was tonight's main event, so obviously they know, like, their role is to, let's have our main event.
Even if they voted no, that poll would have said yes somehow, someway last night. All right, we had Dean Ambrose defeated Bad News Barrett. We had A New Day comes out.
The only
not
thing worth mentioning
on
there was
day.
holy shit,
I put up a video on YouTube. You know that guy that's like, I don't believe in
gay.
I'm not gay no more.
I don't like men's no more.
God,
I'm a women's now.
Biggie
I'm
came out.
I'm not gonna wear makeup no more. It's Biggie. A new day. I'm doing the impression so you can play it off.
Biggie came out and cut a promo and sounded identical to that guy last night.
Which is every stereotypical black.
I know where they got that gimmick from, man. I know where they got that gimmick
Google
from.
I told you Google or YouTube a slick promo from 1980s.
Right.
Same thing.
The NWO reunion on Raw.
Yeah.
Scott Hall, Kevin Nash, and X-Pac, they all came to the ring. Scott Hall did the Hey Yo thing. Kevin Nash cut the...
We got a plug-in for your site on this before we get going. There's a wicked, badass, awesome photo of the original Click and it's divided perfectly. You got Waltman, Hall, and Nash in the ring.
That's awesome.
Shawn Michaels, Triple H outside the ring, and they're looking and talking. And they've all holding their scripts for the show.
Right.
And they're all before the show started. And this is like an off camera a picture. WZRonline.com. It's badass.
Yeah, check it out.
I think it's like one of the coolest.
Check it out.
Like. Historical photos.
So we had Scott Hall does his heyo thing. Kevin Nash comes on, cuts a little promo. X-Pac is
heyo.
Yeah. So X-Pac grabs the microphone and he's like, "Dallas, Texas, what's up?"
Nash grabbed it.
Something like that. It was Nash that grabbed the second. X-Pac grabbed it.
Yeah, we're known for
Dallas, Texas. Blah blah blah. The Ascension's music then comes on, cuts them off. They come out. They trash talk the NWO, saying basically you're old, you're washed up. Yeah. Da, 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 da. This is where JBL gets up off commentary, grabs his microphone, he goes towards the entranceway, he says, "Hey, I made a phone call, I called somebody tonight," tears his shirt off, APA, Ron Simmons comes out, big hug, they get in the ring, they're about to fucking beat him down, New Age Outlaws.
Didn't know!
No. They take him down. Billy Gunn hasn't aged one bit in God.
Shaved his head
20
years. He's got like a buzz cut.
Hey, he ain't got the long hair anymore, man.
Got rid of that. He's done that in the past.
So he comes
Billy
out.
And Chuck, remember the gay marriage?
Yep, Billy and Chuck. Yeah. So they come out. You've got them all in the ring. They're surrounding the Ascension. JBL hits the clothesline from hell. Give it up for JBL.
They get the big setup too.
He's still got the clothesline from hell, but. Here's the deal, and this is what I want to talk to you about.
This set up a match for the Rumble.
A little bit. It set up a match for the Rumble, but listen, the Ascension were a big deal down in NXT. Yeah. And go ahead, tell them the match.
Well, the match is the New Age Outlaws because they're the only team.
Right.
The new NWO can't work, APA can't work. They're way too bad. You know, New Age Outlaws were just tag champs a couple months ago.
Oh, New Age Outlaws, right.
So, absolutely. Yeah, New Age Outlaws versus the Ascension. Royal Rumble this time.
But here's the deal. The Ascension, if you followed NXT, the Ascension were a big deal. They were Triple H's project down in NXT. They get called up to the main roster, you know, week after week, the Ascension.
Okay.
Week after week, you know, they've been defeating these jobbers, this, that, and the other thing. But they're in there with the Legends last night, and dude,
it mixes because they've been trashing Legends.
I get it. Listen, hear me out, man.
I'm listening.
They
I'm helping them.
Buried him last night, and I understand that they buried him, but
they buried the Road Warrior the week before.
But they were in there with the Legends, so the fact that they were in there with the Legends, I get it.
Don't
but they
say
still,
that boosted them.
They still buried him, and why would you take a tag team that was so popular in NXT?
Now you're on it.
Why would you do that? I don't care that they're in there with the NWO and it makes them
look fucking bad.
It makes them look terrible.
Yes.
Dude, why would you? And I'm thinking to myself, this is Triple H has got to be in the back.
We discussed it last.
Triple H has got to be in the back, rolling his eyes, being like, "Dude."
Well, we missed that in a second too.
I had these guys so.
Oh,
over.
We missed it. We didn't even bring it up.
Hey, hear me out, man.
Oh man, how did we skip that?
Please hear me out, man.
All right, you'll see what I'm talking
Triple
about.
Triple H is sticking to himself.
Go
I
ahead.
Had these guys as a big tag team in NXT. Granted, it's NXT, but you bring them up.
He's
the main
so
roster.
Ashamed.
They've got all the potential. I'm thinking Triple H has got to be rolling his eyes.
He's so embarrassed.
This has got to be Vince. That's not a fan.
How have we not picked up?
Vince
on?
Isn't a fan.
Remember the segment we just glossed over? We didn't even touch on it at the very end. The Nash fake Waltman with Mizdow. At the very end, Nash says, "Is this the kind of fucking show you guys are running this day?" What Triple H
and Triple H goes,
"Yes,
I'm
embarrassed.
So embarrassed.
You know,
that's got to be a shoot at Vince being like, dude,
it's a shoot at the fact that the product sucks.
It sucks.
Yeah.
It's terrible. And Triple H,
whoever
it's at,
who knows?
It.
But he's like admitting, like, yeah, this is."
Triple H,
garbage compared
he even
to what,
said, like you're talking about, even in the promo, Triple H was like, "I'm ashamed, I'm sorry, but it's not my call." Triple H is probably thinking in the back
that's
of that,
the shoot.
It's
and
not
that, he's
my
like,
call.
If I could only get the reins, it would be a better
I could
show.
If I could
NXT.
If I could make the final call on what goes on TV, please. Watch NXT.
Yeah,
that's
what I could do.
You've got guys like the Ascension, right, down in NXT. Triple H made them big time down in NXT.
And now they seem like douchebags.
And now they're jobbers on the main roster. And why is that?
I'll tell you right now.
If Triple H was in charge of the booking of the Ascension on Monday Night Raw, do you think that would have happened last night?
No.
They're
all
Vince
gimmick
McMahon,
different right now.
Vince McMahon is in charge of the booking of the Ascension. And Triple H has got to be going...
Well, the writers are in charge, and Vince agrees to it. But Yeah, no, my thing is...
Do you feel bad for Triple H?
No, I feel bad for the Ascension, because they were damn good in the NXT company.
Triple H was high on the Ascension, right, we know that.
These are the guys that are working and taking the bumps and stuff, so Triple H, yeah, it kind of sucked for him, because he had a great thing going with
him. Those were his babies, man. Yeah. He brings
well, so
the
was
the Rock
family on the Shield, and look how good they're doing.
True,
Rusev,
true.
You know. Right, so he's got his winners
so
and losers.
So Vince doesn't like two guys.
Yeah,
right, right.
You get some, you don't get some.
True.
You can't get them all.
True.
But for those two gentlemen, Victor and Connor, they were doing great in NXT. They were over, they had a great gimmick, it was this and that, and then when they get to the main roster, we're going to make them Legion of Doom Light, Diet Demolition, whatever you want to call them, have them bury all these legendary teams, which they think in their heads is going to get them heat. Oh, they're burying these legends that everybody loves, so everybody's going to boo. Instead,
right.
You got the announcer saying, making it like a joke, like, do they really think they're even in the same league? As the Legion of Doom,
buried them.
That doesn't help them any.
They
think, oh, it's going to get heat on them because, oh, they're trash. These legends. No, you're making it sound like they're not even in this. They can't even carry their fucking sweat jocks. You know what I mean? Like,
buried them from the beginning, bro. All right, listen. The main event of Monday Night Raw last night: John Cena, Seth Rollins, Kane, and The Big Show. Right? It was basically a one-on-three or a three-on-one, however you want to say it.
And this is where the show got interesting.
This is where it got interesting, and then we got to get into rapid fire. We're going to run a little bit long. This rapid fire tonight, we've got to do one-word answers, so we're going to warn you ahead of time tonight. One sentence.
Let me ask you this. What's your... that's wrong.
My favorite... I don't like running down Raw, which is why I'm trying to get through it, but it's just not
happening.
Everybody
watches it. I don't know why.
Everybody watches it, but I'm trying to get through it.
You know what you should do for
now? Just ain't happening with you.
You got your news things?
Yeah.
Take two or three segments from Raw we're talking about, throw it in your news.
That's what I'm trying to do. So, the main event of Monday Night Raw, right? So... You got the whole match, right? Goes about 10 or 15 minutes, right? And all of a sudden, Sting appears on screen. There's a photo of Sting. It looks like a photo.
A lot happened before that, but yeah.
Looks like a photo. A lot happened before that.
You can't tell if it's a photo or if he's really backstage.
Can't tell if it's a photo. JBL's plugging that it's a photo. All of a sudden, lights go out.
Yeah.
Lights go out. Crow hits. Yeah. Crow theme music.
I love that entrance, by the way, now. They never did that in WCW.
He's got a stare like we do WCR Online.
He's doing, yeah.
Slash. And then boom. Chrome music hits. Starts walking to the ring. Goes
Points
through
the
curtain.
Yeah.
Goes through the curtain. Comes out. Comes on stage. Lights are out. Spotlight on him. Points
and
down
now he's
there.
Wearing his multicolored Sting shit. Nobody's mentioned that yet.
All right.
On the Survivor Series, he was just black and white.
Right.
And if you remember TNA, he started to add like red and blue and shit like that to his like jacket that he would wear. He came. That was the Sting that came out on Monday.
So Sting comes out last night, points to the ring. Cena comes up from behind, rolls up Seth Rollins.
One, two, three.
Ziggler, Rowan, and Ryback all get their jobs back. Sting standing on stage.
Cena remains in the title match because he
Cena
had lost.
Remains
he was
in
out
the title
of the
match. So they all get their jobs back. The three guys that were fired get their jobs back. Triple H is all pissed off. He's heated.
He
grabs
the
microphone.
Yeah.
Says, "No, Sting, no, 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 I'm not going to take
this." Their thing.
Throwing the thing, you know, furthering the Triple H for Sting, which is probably going to happen at WrestleMania.
Not probably, it's going to happen,
All right, so, and the show goes off the air.
Yes. No, Brock comes out.
Or Brock comes out,
house.
You're right.
Yeah.
Brock comes out and cleans
Final
house.
Rumble touch, yeah.
Basically, everybody takes everybody out of the ring, and the show goes off the air. So you had Sting returned on Monday Night Raw last night, which is amazing.
I like it. That's his Raw debut.
Raw debut.
First ever time on
Raw. I like it. I
loved
it. I like it.
Loved
man.
It.
But I thought the show overall as a whole, it wasn't.
Fun.
I mean,
no,
it was
the show
maybe
overall,
a C minus.
You seen?
It
the,
wasn't
I don't even
good. Want to
give it a grade. I want to say it was fun plus, not a
we
plus.
Ran
not
down,
a plus. It was fun plus.
We ran down the good segments, right?
There was
all
a lot of
this,
fun shit.
There was some fun shit, but all the stuff in between.
Well, listen. That goes back to the 3-hour, 2-hour argument.
Wasn't
if
good.
You got 3 hours, you're going to have shit all over the show. No matter what, you can't avoid it.
I get it.
You cut it down to 2 hours, you can have great shows. 3 hours, you're never going to have a great show. You're going to have a show with some really cool shit in it.
Right.
And that's
right.
What Monday was, I thought. It was a show with some cool shit in it.
All right.
That's what you're going to get with 3 hours.
No,
there's
I
no
don't.
Way
I
to
know.
Do
you're going to get that filler material.
Yeah.
But
how could you have 3 hours straight of awesome shit, nonstop for 3 hours? You can't. Movies can't do that.
Here we go. We have 4 minutes to get through rapid fire.
Yes.
Gonna have to run a little bit late tonight.
We were in we're in
POTUS is speaking.
We're in
tonight.
Texas.
POTUS is speaking.
We're in Texas
tonight.
For the spoilers.
POTUS is speaking.
We got a delay.
Tonight.
We're good. You son of a bitch.
POTUS.
Who's his fucking Secretary of State?
I'm the GOAT.
JB.
I'm the GOAT.
JB.
JB?
Boehner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
John.
Man, he didn't know.
John.
That's why he's stalling.
John
what
Boehner.
About the Vice President?
Joe Biden.
All right, this son of a bitch. Who was the guy that said, yeah!
Dean Howard.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dean Howard. Dean. Howard Dean.
Howard Dean. When
Howard
did he
Dean.
Say it?
Huh?
When did he say it?
2004.
There you go. There you go.
Woo!
All right.
Dean Mitchell, Jerkaholic in the chat, ask, what's your Rumble
Dino
prediction?
UK.
Oh. And thanks for the BWR plugs last week. Meant a lot to us all.
Hey.
British.
Go ahead.
British Wrestling Radio.
Yes.
Okay. Check it out every...
I think it's BWRradio.com or BWRWrestling.com.
BWR.
Go to
British
Dean Mitchell on Facebook and you'll find it.
British Wrestling Radio. Check it out. Google it. They're on every once a week or something like that.
Especially with accents.
What's your Royal Rumble
prediction?
Who wins the title match?
The title match.
Title match.
Oh fuck me, that's a different.
Rollins, Lesnar, Cena.
I had a Rumble prediction.
Rollins, Lesnar, Cena.
I don't know.
Rollins.
It could be.
Rollins.
It
I'm
could
gonna
be.
Say Rollins. Hurry up. Hurry
it
up.
Won't be Lesnar.
Okay,
I'll
not,
just say that.
Lesnar loses.
Lesnar loses.
Cena or Rollins?
Yes.
Come on, quick.
I don't want to.
Cena Rollins.
I don't know.
We're not writing them down. We're not going to remember.
Oh, this is the last show.
Cena Rollins. I'm Rollins. You go Cena.
I'll go Rollins.
Rollins.
The Cena Morgan Rusev at the.
Royal Rumble winner. Daniel Bryan.
Or Roman Reigns.
Or Roman Reigns.
Yeah,
I agree.
I don't know.
Lance winner.
I'm gonna burp, I'm sorry.
Here we go.
Think Henderson got robbed in UFC. I had a 29-28 for me. He's talking about Benson Henderson.
I know.
Damn. Yeah, he thought Benson Henderson beat Donald Cowboy Cerrone 29-28. A lot of people thought that. A lot of people.
Don Nelson.
I had it 2-1 Cerrone, so did you.
Don Nelson, has Jim Ross agreed to Lucha Underground yet? No. Has not.
He's denying it, yeah.
Denying.
He's saying it's bullshit.
But he denied that he was going to work in Japan,
too.
He denied
the Wrestle Kingdom, yeah, so you never, you can't, his word don't mean shit.
Christopher Brown.
Matthews.
Christopher Brown says, you guys stay out of that trouble in the chat room, man. I got all these emails from poor Christopher Brown and Ryan and everybody else, man. Come on, man. We're all a family. We're all a family here. Stay out of trouble, man. All
right, Christopher Brown says, someone in one of the Facebook groups I'm a member of is suggesting we may see a Lesnar face turn before he leaves. Any thoughts on that? Did you watch Raw last night? Because Lesnar turned face last night.
Man.
That was a baby face Brock Lesnar if I've ever seen
There's
one.
Talk that UFC officials are already coming up with opponents for
Yeah, if they get him, they want him to fight Mir because there's a rubber match there. They've each won one. Who wins the third? And
Joey.
Sell and
Joey Crisioni. Ryan, who is your pick to win the Rumble? I'm going to say it again, man. Daniel Bryan's a Roman Reigns. Anthony
it's
Remy.
One of those two, yeah.
Thoughts on the two ex-WWE talents filed class action lawsuit against
WWE. You wanted to do that anyway. Go ahead. We're not talking about Billy Jack Haynes. That's a separate lawsuit, but this is very similar, but separate. Go ahead. You take it from there, sir. We've had a lot of fun with this off the air. Yeah,
listen, man. Big Vito.
Hey.
Big Vito and another indie wrestler have sued WWE.
I thought it was another name. Like a shitty name, but like a name.
It's an indie wrestler. I can't even remember his name.
I could swear I know the name.
But they're suing WWE for concussions and everything else over the years.
Class action lawsuit, which is not no small... That's not small potatoes. That's a big deal.
Listen.
Big Vito's nuts.
He put us on the map. He put us on the map.
Yeah. In all seriousness. Listen, I know you
If
do,
I can be
hey,
serious
listen, we,
for
we
a minute.
We joke around, but he put us on the map. Brian, no. Listen.
Don't
guys,
hit me.
Stop the show real quick.
You
I know,
get
listen,
this
no, 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 listen, listen.
You get me fucking wound
listen,
up.
Listen.
You get me wound
I know
up
we have
this,
fun.
Man.
We have fun. We're on here 2 hours.
Yeah, we do.
We joke. We have fun. But if we're being serious, Big Vito is the reason we're sitting here today.
Absolutely.
Big Vito is the reason I'm sitting in this
Absolutely.
Chair right now.
Absolutely.
Big Vito is the reason you got a roof over your head. Let's not forget. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Fucking Big Vito's a
Let me
psycho.
Tell
you,
you
had nothing to do with it, buddy.
Let me tell you something,
you
man.
You came on the show.
Let
we
me
were,
fucking
we
tell
were
you something.
7 years into our career
Vito,
already.
Vito, I'll tell you right now,
Hold
bro.
On.
Bro.
I love Big Vito, but he's
for,
a fucking retard.
For
that's
7, 8 years, I was doing this job.
Yeah.
And I made a
and
goddamn,
I've been doing it longer than
I made a goddamn good living for myself.
Yes.
And so did Boone. We made a good fucking living. That motherfucker came onto this radio show back
when his career was going on the toilet.
He came on to this radio show.
WCW folded. He had nowhere to go.
You were nothing.
Yeah.
You got fired from WCW.
No, WCW, not fired.
WCW didn't want him. WWE didn't want him. You came on to this radio show. You contacted us.
Yes.
You contacted Boone and I to come on here because we had a big old fucking radio show. We had a big old website that we were running. You came on here to us. You contacted us to promote something. We said, sure, we'll have you on. You're an ex-WCW
star. And then we had so much fun with him.
You come on here. You're a good dude. We had a good time with you.
Anytime he asked.
We had a good time with you.
Anytime he asked. Hey, can I plug this? Yeah, come on, man.
Less than 2 years ago,
anytime.
You come back here. It's a reunion. You're back on here with Clark and Boone, the two guys that had you on our radio show to plug something when your career was
half
shit.
His Wikipedia
you
page
come on
to
our
show.
Radio show, and you say that if it wasn't for me, you guys wouldn't be where you are today.
Right.
If it wasn't for you, you guys wouldn't have a website. You wouldn't be making the money you're making today. This, that, and the other.
Feeding your promo.
We had you on our fucking radio show when you were a nobody, when WCW went out of business, and here you are saying you made us.
I gotta jump in.
And now you're now because WWE doesn't want you, because TNA doesn't want you, because Ring of Honor does, because nobody wants you. Nobody wants you because you're old. Now you're gonna file a class action lawsuit against WWE.
Because you got no money, dude. Well, now I gotta jump in for two.
Fuck
reasons.
Out of here.
Hey, you don't
fuck
know.
Out of
Maybe
here.
He did take some wicked. Who knows? I don't want to say that. They're putting us on the map.
Fuck that
stuff,
guy,
though.
Man.
It's worth mentioning.
Fuck that guy.
He didn't. Cause like, listen, if you say what you just said and they listen to it, they say, "Well, dude, he was clearly joking. He was not joking. He said it like this." He didn't say, I put you two guys on the map. Because anybody could just take the, he's just joking. He was not joking. He specifically said, I know we joke around a lot, we have fun, but if we're being, we got to be serious for a second, not like Lance Storm. He was being dead serious, not no angle, no gimmick. I know we joke around, we have fun, but if we're being serious, you guys know I put you on the map. But, and then he kept continuing with whatever his point he was making was. But he wanted to feed his point by saying, like, blah, 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 and I know we joke around and we have fun and this and that, but if we're being serious, I put you guys on the map, blah, 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 blah. Like, it was like an afterthought to him. But it fucking struck me, and I didn't let it go. If you watch that archive, I'm like, Vito, you did not put us, we were already making a living, and well-known, and multiple years deep into this show, let alone our careers as writers, before we interviewed you for the first time, and eventually, anytime you'd email us, which eventually became every 2 weeks, hey, can I plug this? Hey, can I plug that? Hey, can I plug this? And we would always say yes, because he was like a fun guy.
Always.
He was a fun guy to dick around with on the air.
Say, can I plug this? Can I plug that? Can I plug
my
website?
And then he said that dumbass comment, and right there, him and Vito do not talk to this day. Me and Vito are still cool. You don't like him, he don't like you.
No.
They don't get along no more. He took that real seriously, as did I. But I handled it in a way where we were able to at least keep a semblance of friendship.
I got him blocked.
He wasn't able to do
I
it.
I got him blocked. Yeah. I got him blocked in my email.
Yeah.
He can't email me. I blocked his email
Twitter.
Because he kept emailing over and over and over.
I remember. I was here.
Trying to get me to fucking do something. And I finally blocked his email. I blocked his Twitter account. I blocked his Facebook account. I got him blocked on every fucking thing.
You guys
talked
shit a little bit first, and then,
There was
a request for a phone call, and you said, fuck him and his fucking
That guy, he wanted a phone call.
Yeah.
He wanted a phone call.
Fuck him. I don't want to talk to him.
And I'm still.
You told him that to his fucking face. A phone
call's not coming anytime soon, bro. No.
Vito, I'll still talk. I love you, man. You can't help but love him. He's a fucking character. Like, even in real life.
Character. He came on here and he'd be the happiest son of a bitch one moment.
Really
and the next
depressed.
Moment,
yeah.
Oh, just so depressed.
I thought that was good radio.
And then off air, I don't have a job anymore, man. I'm struggling, man.
Yeah.
I can't, I'm trying to. I'm working at a used car dealership now, man. And da 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 da. Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. I'm making a good fucking living right now. Where are you at, dude? Working at a used car dealership, you fucking piece of shit. Fuck you.
Listen, it's when you're right, you're right. I mean, it's just kind of fucked up to be that right now.
So, Anthony Remy, you want my thoughts on two ex-WWE talents?
Put your dress back on and shut up? Is that what you're thinking?
Put your fucking dress back on and get the fuck out of here.
Oh, God. David Hadley. Is this the post-rap part? Yeah, Vincent Nguyen. If you guys watched Total Divas this past Sunday night, I haven't actually. First time. How about that sexual tension between Natalya and Paige? Thoughts on that, Ryan and Matt? So they're doing a lesbian angle.
They are. I saw the
highlights. They haven't tagged him. Is it this Sunday? Yeah. This Sunday again.
It's Rosa and Paige. Rosa's got a crush on
Raw, it was Paige and Natalya against Summer Rae and Alicia Fox. They won.
Right.
And they announced, Bell Twins were in commentary, and they announced Bell Twins versus Natalya and Paige for Royal Rumble.
Right.
So, they're having them as a team, but I guess they're doing a lesbian angle.
Continue that on Total Divas. Vincent Nguyen again, David. Yes, it is. All right, Matt Johnson, that's for you, man.
Matt Johnson says, Boone, Anderson Silva versus Nick Diaz, who you got? And then he asks you something, so we'll stop right there. I got Silva. And because we can't elaborate, I'm just going to say the name Silva.
Who was that?
Anderson and Nick Diaz.
Anderson. Oh, man.
Was it really that hard?
Silva, yeah. I'm a big fan of Diaz.
I am too, but he's not going to win.
Not a fan of his attitude, but I'm a fan of his
work. He's going up in weight to find a guy that's even better than him.
Also, Ryan, what's the false promises and guaranteed week after week about the guest appearing? We talked about that earlier, man.
He just listed a trillion names.
Piper, Russo, Sonny, Barnett. We addressed
names except Russo.
X-Pac, yeah, man. We addressed them all, man. Early in the show. Check out the archive. By the way, archives are going to be back starting this week, right?
Starting tonight. Yeah, this will be up tomorrow.
All right.
On YouTube.
Yeah. All right. David Hadley's up next.
David Hadley says, thoughts on Daniel Bryan wanting to be the face of SmackDown. Did you
read
that?
Said that in an interview.
He's got a lot of ideas. He wants the King of the Ring to come back.
Right.
He's got like a bunch of ideas. Right. I think it's a good idea, especially if he's going to be jobbing to guys like Bray Wyatt on Raw.
Right, right.
Let SmackDown be his show and let him shine there. And then whatever you want to do with him on Raw, do with him. But let him get over
see
on
what
SmackDown.
Happens. Anthony Remy asked about Royal Rumble predictions. We gave those earlier with the main event in the two main matches. But, you know, we'll see what they do with Daniel Bryan. If he wins the Rumble, then he'll be more than the face of SmackDown. Vincent Nguyen, to add into Matt Johnson's question, Ryan, any chance of Ashley Mazzaro coming on a future edition of WZR-TV to discuss the recent beef situation between her and Tammy Sitch? Yeah, man, I sent her a direct message, never got back to me. I'll send her another one this week and see if we can set something up.
Joseph Gallo, why doesn't Sunny go to rehab? She has about 18 times.
She has, and she should again these days from what
sounds
people are saying.
Like it, yeah.
And
so. You never know. Jay Mullins, you. Go ahead.
I enjoyed Raw last night. I thought the ending was a great way to hype up the Rumble title match.
I agree.
Speaking of Lesnar, I have a feeling Heyman will turn on Lesnar at the Rumble and help Rollins win the title.
Wouldn't shock me at all.
Well, if Lesnar's leaving,
wouldn't shock me.
Heyman's still going to be on TV.
Especially if Brock's in the babyface for the last few matches, which they kind of teased on Raw.
Although that would put Heyman with the authority. Yeah.
Makes perfect sense.
All right. All right. Yeah. I like that, man.
You need to click play on that clip.
I like that. We can hit play.
There's another question before. What is the deal with the Ascension? They're getting their legs cut out from under them before they really even stood up. Yeah, no, that's what we said earlier. They're having them trash these legends, and they're basically a joke before anybody even knows who they are. The first impression is, they're clowns.
Right.
They pretend like they're better than the best of all time people.
Right.
And the best of all time people, like NWO, New Age Outlaws, APA, you know, stand up, you know. So, yeah, they're clowns, and they're never going to be anything real because WWE screwed them from the gate, you know.
Right now, they're clowns, and I think that it's Vince McMahon's decision, man. I don't
think... It is. He will tell you. He's got final say, and that's what he said. Yeah, let's do that with him.
He's got final say. And then one more thing here from Mario Castranelli. His comment is...
2004, it even says.
This
it, right?
is Mario's comment here.
Well, you guys.
Yeah!
He hasn't done it yet, I don't know. Tell me something, Herb.
Gotta get the pill pop.
Oh, Howie's right.
You know something? Not only are we going to New Hampshire, Tom Harkin, we're going to South Carolina, Oklahoma, Arizona, and North Dakota, and New Mexico.
Here we go.
We're going to California.
Yeah! Woo! Awesome, bro. You're the man. You're the man.
That's awesome. Mario Castagnoli, I think he's the guy that did the awesome, unbelievable amounts of snow. I think he's that
David
guy.
Hadley, why does Daniel Bryan have to win the Royal Rumble to get a title shot? Kayfabe-wise, shouldn't he be automatically granted a championship opportunity since he never lost?
Any champion whoever wins the title gets an automatic rematch.
Good point.
Didn't get one, yeah.
Good point. So Vincent Nugent up next.
Vincent Nugent says, what do you guys think about the latest re-signings of male and female talents at TNA Re-Center over the last week? We talked about that.
Talked about that earlier. David Hadley again. What does WWE gain by blocking indie companies from WrestleMania week? They don't want companies. Everybody comes into town. They flock into town for WrestleMania week. You know, indie promotions try to capitalize off all
WWE's
the wrestling
trying to block
fans.
That this year.
They're trying to block it.
They're trying
to block it every
No, this is like the first time they're really going cutthroat with it.
They
business
try to
style.
Block it every
year. No, I know.
Year.
But this is the first year they're getting cutthroat, and they're really trying to fuck them with it.
I think it happens every
year. No, they do. But, all right, we don't have enough time.
All right.
I'm trying to be quick. Vincent Nugent says, Ryan and Matt, did you guys watch any MMA and boxing events from this past weekend? Aside from UFC Fight Night 59, which you guys may have watched, but give us your thoughts thoughts on it.
I didn't watch any boxing.
No. UFC Fight Night 59. We watched that, Conor McGregor and all that. And if so, what were your brief thoughts on Bellator 132? We didn't watch that. World Series of Fighting 17. We didn't watch that. Showtime Boxing and Bermain Stevern versus Dante Wild. We didn't watch any of that. No. Sorry.
Brandon Brown, with DDP being rumored for the Rumble, do you think Jake Roberts will be there too? Since he has said in the past he wants to be in the Rumble.
And he did an interview with Sports Town Chicago just last week.
Okay.
They emailed me, Peter Ferrari or something like that. His name. I can't.
Have they contacted? Contacted them or not?
They contacted me. Jake talked to them. They got an interview. It's an audio interview. It's
Tom Askin has WWE contacted Jake.
Jake says he's in the Rumble.
He's in the Rumble?
He said it. Oh, no. He says part of WrestleMania weekend.
Part of WrestleMania.
He didn't say what part, he's doing, but he's part of WrestleMania weekend.
All right.
That's what he said.
All right, no doubt.
So probably Rumble, I would think.
I think a DDP.
Or no, he said
he's
part of the road to WrestleMania. And that's why I assumed he would be in the Rumble as a surprise. Because if you remember last year, he was dying to be a surprise guy in the Rumble, and they said, no, Hall of Fame. Remember, even that video came out.
Sounds like they're doing a lot of surprises.
Remember that video where he
pretended
to DDP? He's like, I wanted to be in the Rumble, and they told me that I can't.
Right.
And he's like, pretending he was crying, DDP's like, oh, man, really? They told me instead that I'm going to be in the Hall of Fame! And DDP's like, oh, you motherfucker! You're going to be in the Hall of Fame for real?
Right.
Yeah. Matt Johnson says, why is the IWC, the internet wrestling community, including yourself, Clark, at times so quick to jump to conclusions regarding storylines, etc.? Just curious, serious question. And I would love to know the answer to that myself. This guy will take a very small thing and fucking run with it. He'll be so sure, and you can't convince him that he's wrong when he's got his mindset. You can't be like, dude.
He's not going to go on a rant, but the IWC is very quick to judge on storylines and myself sometimes. I come on here and I say, what are they doing? I mean, listen, I said that they're burying the Ascension. Who's to say that in 2 or 3 months from now, the Ascension may not be a big deal, you know? We're all very quick to judge storylines and angles, and
because of our job, we have to react as soon as something happens. So we're not quick to judge. It's our job to say what we think when we see shit.
We gotta get
out
of here.
So we're not judging anything.
Right.
But you remember Randy Orton's initial thing was the Legend Killer. For months, years, his thing was he'd spit in this legend's face, RKO this legend. I think the Ascension is a similar thing.
But they're
calling
being
out
jobbed
all
these,
out. No, they haven't jobbed anybody yet.
Big job last night.
Oh, they're not going to beat the fuck out of the New Age Outlaws this Sunday?
I would hope so.
So when it gets time to fight, they're bad motherfuckers.
All right.
But they talk a lot.
We had Brandon Brown. What do you think of
that's
Triple H breaking
doing.
Character during the backstage segment with the Click and Nash? We talked about that earlier with the kind of, I'm ashamed.
Yeah.
Da, 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 da. We got Allie Adair. Allie, I tried to contact you last week over the WZR t-shirts. Told you to email me. Never did, bro. But I got a hold of you.
Was last night an attempt to boost ratings because they've been sucking lately? I think so. Anytime they do those kind of theme shows, I think they're hoping for ratings.
You do the Raw reunion and then the post-Rumble show, you know you're going to pop a good
and
ratings.
Last night, real quick, was the first show without Monday Night Football or the college playoffs.
True.
The first time they didn't have any of that shit
Still
against
got the
them.
Celebrity Apprentice, the Bachelor.
But it's their first time where that same demographic isn't having something where they're clearly going to watch that instead. Like you, what would you watch? You wanted to watch college football. Ohio State, you didn't want to watch
Raw. I would have watched Raw. Sean Smith, what do you think about the New Japan Wrestling show?
On Access TV?
Yeah, I haven't watched that.
I heard it's great.
Jackie's here. We're doing phone calls. No, not tonight, Jackie. John Morgan.
Vince is pissed off that, comparatively, NXT is flourishing under Triple H while Raw is floundering to draw positive reviews. That's why the Ascension is getting buried.
I think so, man.
I wouldn't disagree with that.
I think Vince is behind the burial of the Ascension, and if Triple H was booking them, I think that it would be a whole different story. All right. Ali Adar, one more. By the way, you guys never replied to my email still. Ali,
you never sent me an email.
I don't have an email from you. Yeah. I contacted you on Facebook last week. I said, please email me, webmasterprowrestlingscoops.com.
Yeah.
No email.
I've never received one
Webmaster@prowrestlingscoops.com.
Never received one email from the WZR Army. I don't ever get my email out. That's why.
That's Tuesday night.
We're going to call that Tuesday
Tuesday night.
Yeah, I don't know why you're in such a rush.
Because the POTUS is speaking. We got SmackDown spoilers. What do you care what he's saying? A little bit of a delay. There's a lot of stuff that I got to get
up, man.
It's
going to be like John Jones.
I'm trying every week. I want to have this show go from 8 to 10 Eastern time.
Yeah.
Somehow, we came on here. Even 2 minutes early tonight, man. We got to get out of here. There's a lot of stuff. You don't have to work.
I don't have to work? Are you kidding me?
When we go off,
I got more shit to do than you when we get off the air.
When we go off the air,
I got
here
more
tonight.
Shit to do than you when we get off the air.
I got 7 posts that I
got
to put up.
That I've already got up.
And
that I've already got up.
That you already have up?
Of course.
You don't have them up.
Of course.
You don't have
Name
them up.
Name one.
I can tell you. Name one. I can tell you the ones we don't have up. Big Vito speaks on the class action lawsuit.
We're not covering that story.
You have that?
We don't care about the story.
You're not covering it.
No.
I am covering it.
No.
So I got Vito.
You cover the initial thing. We don't care what he's saying about it. No.
So I got that. I got a preview for tomorrow night's Lucha Underground.
That's already up.
With a video. Yeah. It's not up.
Yes, it is.
It is not.
Not on the site you're thinking about that you go to, but
it's not up.
On our other sites, yes, it is.
All right. I got
the sites that matter that we get paid for, not the one that we plug on. Yeah.
God. Get out of here. I got a lot of stuff that has to
And I
got to
do all
tonight.
The MMA shit still, too, asshole.
That's MMA.
You got to do that?
That's MMA.
That's my job.
I don't
give
a fuck.
50% of my job. It ain't yours. It's still mine.
Get out of here.
That's how I get paid. I got to do it.
Well, so you got work to do.
I got
work to do. I don't want to be up until 4 in the morning.
I don't either.
So
I don't
get
wanna,
out of here.
I don't want to make the show
That's why I control the pace of this show.
Yeah, that's why the show kind of sucks sometimes.
It doesn't suck sometimes. I got
to
fucking
It'll be good to have an archive this week. You got to check the YouTube channel.
Well, Jesus, who does the archives? Why haven't there been archives the last couple of weeks
you
because
you
were
fucking,
too goddamn
you
lazy
because
you were
why.
Too goddamn lazy to download a simple FTP
there wasn't,
program
I didn't have that
a
program.
Simple FTP program all you gotta do is
the
do
second he gave it to me I downloaded it
all
2 seconds I stopped exactly what I was doing he said I got
wait a minute,
it
wait a minute how did I get that I went to google.com and I searched
I've never heard of that
I
thing.
Searched for an FTP program something you could have done
never
4 weeks ago
never
but
heard
I
of
said
it.
The fans are
never
upset They're not getting
Never
the archives.
It.
They're not getting the archives.
Never heard of it. He gets his thumb drive away.
I find a free FTP program, and I give it to this guy. And I give it to this. Something
I'm
he could have
right
done
now.
4 weeks
oh
ago.
Oh, my God.
Why are you
saying I've been telling you for weeks. Quit being a pussy. Dan lives 3 doors down.
He doesn't have it.
He does.
I told you. He's telling me he doesn't have it.
All right, well, then
and you know
what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do?
Go to Google.com, search
you
for
never,
free FTP.
I did.
Just like
I
did.
I did. I had
just
a trial.
Just like
I
did.
I had a trial for 30 days.
Download.
I had a trial for 30 days. It expired. What the fuck do I do after that?
Go find a new FTP
program. There isn't one.
There's tons of them out there.
I've never heard of them.
You gotta do a Google search.
Don't even use FTP in 12 years. Everything's WordPress now.
You gotta do a Google search for a free
FTP.
Yeah,
get a virus
like
trying to find one. And get the virus and trying to find one.
You can tell the difference between a virus and a fucking...
We damn near got
on, you're smart enough for that.
Did we not download the wrong
you're
thing?
Smart enough
he came
for
in
that.
Here and he said, yo, here it is. Did we download it and it was the wrong thing, wasn't it? It was the wrong thing.
It was not a virus.
But it was the wrong thing.
Server.
Oh, it's obvious. You could tell it's obvious.
It was a
It was the wrong
virus.
Thing.
So we went back and downloaded the right
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, when you fucking looked
it
up. It
wasn't a virus.
You looked it up in your day fucking years old fucking logs and found it. I don't know that. What am I going to do?
Ladies and
Just
gentlemen.
Just fucking show. It's my
ladies,
job to get his archive
ladies
off.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I don't make any fucking money on this show.
Folks.
What the fuck are we talking about?
You got to be kidding me right now.
This is your job. My
you
whole
gotta
room
be kidding
gets
me.
Turned inside out every week to do this dumb shit. I don't get paid nothing. It's my fault we don't have an archive.
We know we're on the air, John Morgan or Anthony Remy.
Oh, they think we're arguing and we think we're not. Why are we
We're on the air. This is how we do it.
I love this guy.
We air our dirty laundry. I fucking love this guy too, man. All right, brother. Listen, that's Tuesday.
Feedback, archives, we got all that shit coming up. Feedback, we want Facebook.com/MattMoonWZR. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. YouTube will be the archive. It'll be up tomorrow sometime. Check his Facebook. Check my Facebook. We both post links to it. But if you want to go to YouTube directly and add us, subscribe to our channel. It's youtube.com/WZR archive.
I wonder if these two have ever had fist fights. This guy up here. You're still on the air. This guy up here says the
debate. We've had fist fights.
We love you guys, Army. We listen.
Ooh.
That's why we're entertaining, man, because we don't hold back. We come on here every Tuesday.
Yes.
You say what?
We had a fist fight. I caught you with the knee. You bled all over the t-shirt. Slipped
you got
in
the
car.
Me in the face.
You were afraid I was going to go nuts more, and you went
you got
and slept
me with
in
a
car.
Knee in the face. I didn't sleep
I slept
in the car.
I slept in his apartment. He slept in his car.
I remember we were out in the hallway in the old apartment.
You tried throwing me down the stairs. I caught you with the knee. He threw a chair at me. It was this chair, I believe, because it was a metal chair with metal bottoms, and it hit me in the stomach and it hurt. And I remember looking at myself like, motherfucker. Because we had friends over, and I didn't want to have him in my room because his room was bigger, and we had like a fight or a football game, right?
Anthony Remy makes for great radio. It does.
It's fun.
It does.
It's like Jerry Springer.
You got me good. You got me good with a knee.
I caught you. It happens. Right. You caught me in the past. Remember my arm all bruised up? Remember that when I first met you?
Yeah.
Remember? He tried
it was the chest.
No,
the
it
chest
was my arm.
Over
no,
and
you had,
over
you had this
and
too,
over.
But this whole thing was like gross.
Right?
It was like literally from here to here. The entire thing was bruised. All the way around.
That is bad.
All the way around. He caught me up against a wall and elbowed and punched the piss out of me.
He couldn't get out of it. I had a pinned up and I
just
kept going,
beat the fuck out of my arm. And yeah, it was bad, man.
We've had some wars, man.
We've been through it.
I've got him and he's got me. He's got me a couple times too. So, anyways, we're out of here. It makes for good radio. When we argue and we get into it, man, these people are...
As long as it's a good argument.
It's a good argument.
We're arguing about like, oh, no, you left the toilet seat up. No, I did. No, you did. You know,
well, can we get a fucking archive this week?
We got an archive this week.
Not we. Can these guys get an archive this week?
It's your show. You tell them. Can we get an archive this week?
You got to upload it.
The fuck is it my responsibility all of a sudden to give them their
archive? Do we get an archive this week?
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
That'll do it.
We recorded the show on my computer, so I have to figure it out.
Oh, I'm Matt Boone.
That's me.
Ryan Clark.
That's him. I don't have the closing song ready yet, but here we go. All right.
See you next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern Time. Where? On WZRonline.com.
Catch y'all. Started from the bottom, now we're here.